At last, you've arrived. Good, good. There is much to do, and every moment is critical. I'm Overseer Tremel. For decades, I've administered the trials that prove who is and is not worthy to join the Sith Order. The trials are a chance to weed out the weak. Those who face them either survive and become Sith, or die.
Mark my words, I am destined to be Sith.
It wasn't destiny that brought you here. Yes, you are here and ahead of schedule because of me. I expect you to obey. You face your trials, you serve me, and I will make you the most powerful acolyte here.
Why am I skeptical?
Have a critical edge, but recognize who is on your side. The trials themselves are difficult enough, but they are hardly the greatest threat you face. There's an acolyte here named Vemrin. He's your enemy, and he will try to kill you. We must prepare you.
Let him try. I'll destroy him.
With my guidance, someday you'll destroy all your enemies. That practice sword you've arrived with is insufficient. The blade of lesser acolytes. You need a dominating weapon. In the tomb of Ajunta Paul, there's an old armory. A strong Sith warblade awaits you there. The tomb is thick with claw slugs. Deadly, savage creatures. Be speedy, but careful. They've been the end of many an acolyte.
Just tell me where to go.
Once you acquire the warblade,
mark my word.
Yeah, you...
How is it I already have an enemy?
All you need to know is that you are a threat to him, and he to you. We'll make sure you can stand up to that threat. That practice sword you've arrived with is insufficient. In the tomb of the tomb is thick.
If they lack the instinct to avoid me, I'll feed them their heads.
Once you acquire the warblade, I suggest you spend some time in the tomb bloodying it. Then come to me in my chambers in the academy.
I have taken care of your problem with the looters in the tomb.
Ah, then I'll assume my men are dead. Even so, you have done us a great service. Their loss is your gain, I suppose.
I have completed my task, then.
Yes, sir.
Hey there, Acolyte. Hold on a moment. Let me get a look at you. So you're Overseer Tremel's secret weapon. Impressive, to be sure. Afraid the old man waited too long to make his move, though. I'm Vemrin, and unlike you, I've fought and bled for everything I have. I demand respect.
Are you saying I haven't earned my way?
Please, everyone knows what Tremel is doing. If Overseer Tremel had made his move a year ago when I first arrived, he might have had a chance. But now, too little, too late.
This is ridiculous, Vemrin. Let's just kill him and hide the body.
We're not on Balmora anymore, Dulgus. There are rules, traditions. We'll leave the shortcuts to Overseer Tremel and his last pathetic hope here.
My honor is not to be questioned.
We'll see about that. Coming, Dulgus. Be rough.
Hey there.
I'm Vemrin.
You don't want to make me angry, Vemrin.
Believe it or not, I'm trying to keep you from getting killed. If Overseer...
This is ridiculous.
We're not on Balmora anymore.
I'm going to take what's yours, and then I'm going to kill you.
You have no idea the enemy you're making. Coming, Dulgus?
Be right there, Vemrin. Listen to me, you useless priss. Acolytes aren't allowed to murder each other. But accidents happen. It isn't murder without witnesses. No more warnings. Vemrin's the alpha monster here. You go after Vemrin, you die.
Good. You've returned. You seem to be in one piece. Tell me, how do you like your new blade?
Take a look. I've already blooded it.
What are you doing, Father? I only just got my warblade and I've been here 6 months.
I have my reasons, Escala. And you will not breathe a word of this to anyone. Do you hear?
Yes. Yes, Father.
Acolyte, this is Escala, my daughter. She's one of the advanced students here. On her way to becoming Sith. If she minds herself.
I'll keep quiet about your new charge, Father. But I won't be there if whatever you're planning blows up in your face.
Don't mind her, she's just sore that I'm keeping secrets. She growls, but she's loyal. Now, I thought I heard Vemrin's voice in the adjacent chamber before you arrived. Did he make his move so soon?
It was nothing I couldn't handle.
If he didn't attack, he must not fully comprehend the threat you represent. Good, good. Still, I'd hoped we'd have more time. Vemrin's not the type to sniff around for too long before trying to take a bite. In a drive for sheer numbers, the criteria for Academy admittance has been relaxed. Now anyone with Force sensitivity is allowed entrance. Vemrin is mixed blood, the invisible rot eating at the foundation of the Empire. He must not be allowed to advance.
So, you're an elitist snob.
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's the Sith way. Only the best, only the most pure, should be good enough. Unfortunately, Vemrin's caught the eye of Darth Barriss. Good.
I suppose this is sufficient.
What are you doing, Father?
I have my...
Yes.
Acolyte...
I'll keep quiet.
Don't mind her now.
He just introduced himself to me.
If he didn't attack, still, in a drive, Vemrin.
So please, just let me stop him.
Unfortunately, Vemrin's caught the eye of Darth Barriss, one of the most influential Sith lords. He's being groomed to be Barriss's new apprentice. As Darth Barriss's apprentice, the power at Vemrin's fingertips will be considerable. He could change the Sith for the worse. You must proceed to your next trial immediately. I want you to interrogate 3 prisoners in the Academy jails and decide their fates. Consider each criminal's story carefully. The decisions you make will be scrutinized, so let your passions guide your judgments.
I will handle it.
Go to the Academy prison. Speak to head jailer Nash and return to me after you've passed judgment on the prisoners.
One more chirp from you, little bird, and you'll regret it.
Chirp, chirp, chirp.
jerk. If you don't like that, just say so. I can do other animals too. Dire cat, frog dog, quaking monkey lizard, you name it.
You, I'm Jalen Nash. I run these cells in slave pits. You're the acolyte Tremel sent for the test, right? He thinks highly of you.
Then I will repay his faith by sticking to my mission.
You should know this situation is highly unusual. Normally an acolyte goes off well for the interrogation. Overseer Tremel, at these three shipped in for you. He thinks you're the next coming of Exar Kun. But you ought to know, Tremel ain't the only one paying attention to you. Now, these three prisoners have been transferred here for your inspection. You got to interrogate them as needed, and then decide their fate. The convicted are usually executed or given a trial by combat to see if they're worthy. Whatever you decide, you will be the one to carry out the sentence.
As it should be.
Fine. Let's get started. This one on the left.
You freaks aren't getting anything new out of me. Just do whatever you're gonna do.
You can either talk to me or to the Inquisitors, and I promise, I have a much sunnier disposition.
Get lost. I've been through this routine. I already know all your Inquisitors by name.
Impudent to the last. As I was saying, she was sent to kill an Imperial spy in the Yavin system. Throughout her torture, she maintained that she was hired anonymously.
Get it through your damn head! I had no idea he was Imperial, and I don't know who hired me!
So you're telling me you're not a Republic assassin?
I'm not political. I work for whoever pays.
The point is, she doesn't deny the charge. So now you must decide. Execution or trial by combat? Which do you choose?
Neither, actually. She could prove useful. Send her to Imperial Intelligence.
I won't work for free.
You spared her. Interesting.
Please, I am a fellow Sith. Judge me with an open mind and grant me trial by combat, I beg you.
Your name, now.
This part of Waste is Davotek. Once a valued Sith champion, until he botched an important mission and caused 1,000 Imperial deaths. Now look at him.
I served faithfully for 24 years. Then one mistake, and they threw me away. Now I have been left here to rot. Please, let me feel the weight of a weapon once more.
I don't do charity work. Feel the weight of a weapon in your throat.
I die a disgrace.
Good. I won't have to look at his sad, weathered face anymore. Thank you.
And he won't have to look at yours either, Jailer.
Well, this last prisoner's a bit of a puzzle. He's called Breg, and he's a jittery little wretch, suspected of supplying forged documents to Republic agents. Strangely enough, he maintains his innocence, despite being severely tortured.
Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamnalebek.
Come on, who would go to all the trouble of setting you up?
Nibikat nakamak, nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamnalebek.
He's never wavered from that line. And the evidence is circumstantial. I suppose it's actually possible he didn't do it. So, what do you decide?
I don't care if he's innocent or not. Torture him enough and he'll confess.
Shut up, you fidgety fool. The decision's been made. Well, that's sad. You're an interesting one, kid. I can see why people are keeping tabs on you. Head back to Overseer Tremel. See what he thinks of your choices.
Is this everything?
Everything Lord Renning was able to obtain, yes.
Then run back to your master in the beast pens before I cut you in half. Sorry to make you wait, Acolyte. These interruptions are incredibly annoying. On to the business at hand, your test in the jails. First, the assassin, Solence. She attempted to kill an Imperial spy, but was unaware of her client's affiliation. You assigned her to Imperial Intelligence. I commend you, that was excellent thinking. Never waste a potential resource.
Of course, the answer was obvious.
Obvious. Is this
Thank you, Overseer. I am glad you approve.
What's more important is that Darth Barriss would approve. Now, Devotec, the former warrior. He wanted combat, but you struck him down. Perfect. The man was utterly useless.
I do not ever choose to waste my time.
Once something is used up, it should be eradicated. Lastly, the forger you sent back for more torture, even though he seemed innocent. A strong decision. Leave no stone unturned.
And what if it turns out he truly is innocent?
It's always best to know beyond any doubt. After all, what is one man's sanity or life versus the fate of the Empire? Each time, each prisoner, you made the best possible decision. You may yet be able to challenge Vemrin for Darth Barriss' attention. To celebrate, a small reward.
Thank you very much, Overseer.
Thank yourself, Acolyte. It's performances like this that might just beat the extreme odds we're facing. Because I forced you into the Academy ahead of schedule, Darth Barriss will be predisposed to judging you severely. And by severely, I mean fatally. Now, we must hurry to your next trial. Every moment that passes, we risk discovery before we're ready. In the caverns of Mark Aragnos is the beast he left to guard his legacy. Go there, sit among the flames, and wait for the beast to come for you.
You think that's enough information? How about you tell me about this beast?
All you need to know is that it's ferocious and bloodthirsty, and in no way is it a trial for a normal acolyte. Return to the Valley of the Dark Lords and find the tomb of Mark Aragnos. I'll see you when the beast is slain. Good luck.
Stand and account for yourself, Acolyte.
Let's see what you're made of. I look at you and I wonder, are you among the truly loyal, or do you hide treason in your heart?
I am heir to a great Sith bloodline. How dare you even ask such a question of me?
I do what the Emperor commands me to. Your special heritage does not place you above suspicion, nor should it. Intelligence reports indicate this valley shelters traitors. Acolytes who seek to destroy our Emperor's carefully built order and replace it with their own weak-minded heresies.
They hide among the faithful and obedient. But make no mistake, they will destroy us all, given the chance.
We've watched as the traitors scuttle about this valley and plot against us. We know their faces and their names. It is the Emperor's will that the sands of Korriban be slaked with the blood of these traitors. Prove your allegiance by executing them.
It will be a great honor to serve you, my lord.
And in serving me, you serve the Emperor. Remember that as you exterminate those vermin in the valley.
I'll give you the means to identify the traitors. Eliminate enough of them to prove your loyalty. Then return to Inquisitor Arzanen.
I'll be watching your progress with great interest. I watched you deal with those traitors. Well done. That was an impressive display of loyalty. Take this reward as a token of the Emperor's favor, and wear this badge. It marks you as a defender of our Empire.
Stay vigilant. Our enemies lurk where you least expect them.
A fresh young acolyte come to view my experiments. Good. I trust the sight of a messy operating table doesn't disturb you.
What's the situation here?
Understanding the Force's mysteries requires that we seek answers everywhere, even inside a beast itself.
This used to be a Tukata, the hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. On the surface, nothing special.
But I alone can see this creature is an expression of pure dark side energy. Aggression made manifest.
Amazing. How did you learn that?
The Force told me so. A fresh... I trust the sight of a...
Your lab looks like the inside of a beast's belly.
So quick to turn away in disgust. You're denying yourself knowledge and power. This used to be a Tukata, the hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. But I alone can see this creature isn't...
Your ego is overinflated.
I have gazed into the depths of the abyss and found revelations there others only dream of. The Force is alive. It expresses its will in the physical world. This...
Are we another of these forms?
Sith are the highest manifestation of the Force's will. I've dissected hundreds of Tukata, forging a direct connection to the dark side. Each beast I examine advances me toward perfect unity. I now stand at a new frontier, but find myself thwarted. My most perfect specimen, a Tukata mutant, escaped to the tombs before I could analyze it.
Your work is too important to fail, my lord.
Indeed. Perhaps the Force has brought you to me for a reason. You acolytes delve those tombs on your trials. You could hunt that Tukata for me and retrieve its perfect brain. My apprentice, Melora, saw which tomb the mutant beast fled into. Find out what she knows, assist me, and you'll be rewarded.
Why not send your apprentice to recover this beast?
She's more suited to the laboratory than the tombs. She lacks your fire, I'm afraid. Ask Melora where to seek the Tukata and return to me when you have its brain.
Seeking Lord Renning's lost pet, are you? Don't waste your time. That fool's research is pointless.
I stalk a deadly beast, not some harmless vermin.
That may be, but you still risk your life for nothing. Renning deludes the Dark Council into believing he's advancing Sith knowledge. The truth is, he wastes the Empire's time and resources dissecting mindless animals. But if his experiments were discredited, he would be banished, and I would be rewarded.
What am I supposed to do about it?
Look, just a minor... Seeking...
I stalk a dead...
That may... But if...
Tell the Dark Council he's insane. I'm sure they'd listen.
Don't be naive. The Dark Council would never believe the word of an apprentice over her master. Look, just a minor alteration to the mutant Tukata's brain would allow me to reveal my master as a fraud. Bring me the brain before delivering it to Lord Renning, and I'll make it worth your while.
I'll see if the mood strikes me.
You'll earn rewards from both the master and his apprentice. It's a better deal. The mutant Tukata escaped to the tomb of Mark of Ragnos. It's much larger than the others, so it's easy to spot. Return to me with the brain before you see Lord Renning, and I'll take care of the rest.
I'm running out of patience. Have you finally acquired the mutant Tukata brain, or should I send someone else?
I have what you asked for.
Ha! Wonderful! Let me see it.
You won't have any complaints.
Look at the mottling along the frontal lobe. I'm running out...
I have what you asked for. Hope you don't mind if the brain got a little scrambled.
I don't need it to be in pristine condition. Half the fun of my work is poking through the layers. You've done me a great service, but now I must continue my research. If there's nothing else?
Melora asked me to sabotage your experiment.
Is that so? Melora, if you can't show my work the appreciation it deserves, there's no place for you as my apprentice.
Wait, Master. It's a lie. I haven't betrayed you. Have you recovered the mutant Tukata brain yet? I'm eager to conclude the business we discussed.
It's all yours. Enjoy.
Excellent. This chemical will make it appear as though Renning is falsifying his research. There. All that remains is for me to whisper the right words in the wrong ears. I'm transferring credits to your account now. Give Renning the brain and collect his reward, too. You've made out quite well.
Pray this doesn't come back to haunt me.
Save your tiresome threats. I'll take care of everything. Have you recovered the
Tell me what happens now.
When everyone knows Renning's research is faked, even his closest allies will turn their backs on him. Once he's completely isolated, I'll arrange to be rid of him forever. We shouldn't be seen speaking again. Lord Renning might suspect us. Give him the brain.
You have the brain at last. Excellent work. I trust it wasn't too much trouble.
I punished the foul creature for the trouble it caused you.
My apprentice, Melora, could learn from your example. She's much too soft-hearted. I must continue my research at once. Great discoveries await. Take a reward and go.
You might want to consider bathing sometime.
Yes, yes, you may stop talking now. Goodbye.
Well, look who's here. Remember me?
I never forget a face. Your name is Dolgus, right? Vemrin's boy.
Very good. It's good to know the name of your killer. Notice anything interesting? No witnesses. No witnesses means no rules. No more shortcuts. No more special treatment. You're just going to be another dead failure on Korriban.
No! Hold up! Look, I was wrong. What they're saying about you? Totally true. So strong. I don't want to die.
I'm afraid it's a little late for begging. What will you give me to let you live?
Here, I've got a few credits. Take them! No! Hold up! Look, I was wrong. What they're saying about you? Totally true. So strong. I don't want to die.
Ask for no mercy and expect none. Die like a Sith.
I failed you, Vemrin.
We must speak quickly, Acolyte. There isn't much time. I may have made a slight miscalculation. The beast of Mark Aragnos was a great source of dark energy here on Korriban. When it was slain, there was a tremor in the Force. Darth Barriss felt that tremor and has become aware of you. He demands an audience.
Tell me what to expect, Overseer.
Barriss is a serious man, but a master of deception. Everything he does and says is calculated. He will attempt to trip you up, test your nature, get to the heart of who you are. Always take him seriously. And I mean always.
Consider me warned.
We might not speak again, Acolyte. You're the best chance of stopping Vemrin. If you fail, I doubt there will be another strong enough. Good luck. Meet Darth Barriss in his chambers, and hurry. He won't take kindly to waiting.
Come here, child. Do you intend to explore the Academy? You should linger here a while. I am Overseer Raggate, a keeper of the old ways. I sense you have potential.
Everyone in the Academy seems to sense my potential.
But you have not yet come into your own. You have power and strength in the Force. I administer the rite of blood and bone, a ritual performed beyond this doorway. It is a rite acolytes have participated in for 10,000 years.
I'm sure you were young and pretty back then.
Yes, I am shriveled. I am infirm. Yet, I survive. More than most Sith can say. Learn from my example. In the chambers past the gateway, there is a colony of Shyrax, my leather-winged, razor-taloned children and their brood. They guard a mountain of skulls. An altar to the Academy's failures. You must reach the bones before proceeding.
I'll make a bloody heap of Shyrax bones to match.
It would be a pity if no Shyraks were left for the other acolytes. You must claim a skull from the mountain and return to the antechamber. Soak the skull in the blood pool and come to me. Once bone has turned red, I will look and see your nature written in crimson stains. And possibly a glimpse of your future.
I'll admit, that does sound intriguing.
To complete the rite is to accept one's death, to steal one's own mortality and drown it in the fluid of life. That is the symbolic purpose. But it is also a trial of power, as are all Sith trials, a trial to test strength and to grant it. I will await you here. If you die, I will forget you. I heard the screams of the Shyraks and the rippling of the blood pool. I know you brought the red stained skull, and I must say, I am pleased.
I didn't even break a sweat.
Then you have a darker heart than most. The skull you carry, your rage, your actions drowned it with the dark side. It is part of you. I can offer a small gift, but more than that, I can offer a glimpse of your destiny. There's much I can read in the bones.
Who am I to turn down free advice?
Very well. Listen carefully. The key to your success is a small and sorry creature, but you can shape it in your image if you so desire.
What key? What creature?
That is all I see for certain. I can say no more. Prize what you have accomplished here. You are part of a tradition almost as old as Korriban itself, and you have done well. Goodbye now, young Sith. This lesson is complete.
So, yet another acolyte stands in the shadow of our academy.
Tell me, you who would be Sith, have you seen much of our civilization so far? Have you been awed by this world's power and glory?
Indeed I have. Korriban is most inspiring, my lord.
You find it so? Then you should understand something. Korriban was wrought by the true-blooded Sith millennia ago. Our ancestors, a crimson race of conquerors, raised the statues around us. Over the eons, however, our people mingled with slaves. Now the red markings of true Sith are rare, and the purity of this planet is in question.
And what about me? Are you doubting my purity?
No, you are young. It is your masters who concern me. True purity and strength are carried in the blood. I worry that our blood is being diluted over generations. In the Emperor's name, I have come to learn whether the Academy's overseers are Sith or not. You will be my instrument.
Who are you to judge whether Sith are pure or inferior?
As an agent of the Emperor and the Dark Council, I will report to them, and if necessary, seek ways to restore hereditary supremacy. I possess an ancient device, a holocron, that can read and record bloodlines. It will pulse with life near the overseers. Allow the holocron to fulfill its purpose. Stand near the overseers as it attunes to their blood purity. Then return here, and I will learn the truth.
There, Tino. I believe that's the one.
Really? All right. Hey, you!
Careful, Tino.
Come on, I'm antsy for some action. You there! Are you the big shot they're all talking about? The one who's been personally summoned by Darth Barriss himself?
News sure does travel fast.
Please pardon my over-eager friend. It's just that we've heard so much about you.
And we want to get in good with you.
Tino, what my blunt partner here means is that if you need anything or anyone, say, dealt with, we'd like you to consider us.
She's talking about Femrin. We'll kill him for you.
Sorry. I should have had Tino muzzled. So, what do you say? We know Vemrin tried to have you killed. Would you like him eliminated?
I'm preserving the pleasure for myself.
Far be it for us to rob you of such an experience, but consider this. There are rules. Acolytes are not to openly kill one another. Everyone knows of your rivalry. If you kill him, the lords will presume your guilt.
But if Vemrin croaks while you get an alibi, people might be suspicious, but they won't be able to pin it on you. See?
I wouldn't be upset if Vemrin turns up dead.
Say no more. Go about your business. We'll handle this with utter discretion.
What does this mean, Fine?
It means Vemrin is a dead man, and we're going to have the most potent of allies.
Most of you will not re- Most of you will not return from this endeavor. If you die, you will be forgotten. If you give up, you will be killed. Now, out of my sight.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You should. This is the end of the line for you, Clemeral. Just make sure you stay out of my way.
Look here, Vemrin. I see the upstart, but no sign of Dolgus.
Clemeral, Vemrin, you have been dismissed.
Yes, Master.
I underestimated you by sending Dolgus. It will not happen again.
Are you having trouble with Acolyte Vemrin, Supplicant?
If he insists on getting in my face like that, he's gonna have trouble with me.
He has been hardened into a lethal machine. Vemrin has paid his dues. He's fought a deck stacked against him to get here. You, on the other hand. Let me get a closer look at you. Yes, as I suspected. Overseer Tremel has done you and this academy a great disservice. Your warblade came early. Prisoners flown in for your convenience. Even a beast here on Korriban instead of off-world in the wild. The pacing of the trials is deliberate. Only full immersion over time produces results. Your mind is soft, unhoned, undisciplined.
I disagree, emphatically.
The first month of trials should be dedicated to philosophy, conceptual tactics, understanding of the Sith Code. Recite the Sith Code for me, Acolyte, and explain its meaning in battle, war, and politics.
Sure, give me a minute. Well, you see, there's the dark side, the light side, and there you have it.
Pathetic. I can read.
Nothing gets under my skin.
He is thoroughly. Vemrin has paid.
I disagree.
The first month.
The only code I need to know is kill or be killed.
Your ability is undeniable, but your readiness and your understanding of the Sith way is woefully lacking. I am your master now. Tremel was becoming lax before you ever arrived. His unwillingness to adapt to the evolving Sith paradigm has become a liability. These are the actions of a traitor. Traitors are executed. I grant you immunity from punishment. Kill Tremel and bring back his hand as proof.
As you decree, my lord.
Now leave. I'm sure Tremel is still in his chambers. Don't return until you've killed him.
I didn't expect to see you again so soon. Has Barriss sent you back to me?
I'm here to kill you.
Then I have been outplayed. Barriss has the authority, but I did not think he would do something this overt. Either I die, or he forces me to kill you, and to destroy my own plan. A master stroke. Very well, you have your orders, Acolyte. Know that it gives me no pleasure to kill you.
What makes you so sure you're going to kill me?
You're strong, acolyte, as strong as any I've seen come through the academy. But you're not Sith yet. I'll try to make your end quick and painless. It's the least I can do. Now, I'm amazed. I knew you were strong in the Force, but not like this.
You're more than ready to challenge Vemrin. Barriss won't be able to deny that now.
He'll have the satisfaction of my death. But I die knowing my success. Go ahead. End this.
You're getting ahead of yourself. I only need your hand.
What? Wait. I think I understand.
Barriss demands my hand. Proof of my death. I don't want your pity, acolyte.
That's the deal. Take it or leave it.
I'm a credit to the dark side. My cause is just. You can see clearly, even if Barriss cannot.
Take my hand. Well, that didn't tickle. I'll rest and then leave Korriban covertly.
That's exactly what's needed.
Of course. Goodbye, acolyte. Now,
you're here.
You're getting ahead of yourself.
What, Barriss?
It's not pity. I don't want you to die.
I'm a credit to the dark.
Take my hand. Well, that didn't tickle. I'll rest and then leave Korriban covertly.
Just be thankful you're not dead.
Of course. Goodbye, acolyte. Rid the Sith of that plague, Vemrin. My hopes lie with you.
What's this? The acolyte returns, and with a bloodied weapon. I assume this means Tremel is no more. Give me his hand. Here, take this one ring as a memento. Remembering the past can strengthen resolve and embolden the spirit. I am impressed you had the fortitude to destroy him. You know he thought of you as family. How did it feel to betray him?
It was a day I will long remember. I savored it completely.
Good. Feast on that. Not every kill will be as meaningful. What's this?
I did what was called for.
You mask your feelings well, as long as you don't suppress them. You have taken your first step to understanding the Sith Code. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion, we gain strength. Through strength, we gain power. Through power, we gain victory. And through victory, our chains are broken. The Force shall set us free. By embracing the code and destroying Tremel, you have freed yourself from his shackles. And escaped his fate.
And now I'm bound by your shackles.
You'll find they are a marked improvement. with much greater potential range. Now, there are sacred ruins in the tomb of Tulak Horde. The ancient inscriptions that once adorned the walls of each ruin lie in pieces. You will venture through the entire tomb, search all of the ruins, and bring me a shard from each of these inscriptions. You will do this, or you will die. Vemran and my other acolytes have already been sent. There are no rules regarding how they secure the shards, and they will stop at nothing. Fight your way through the tomb of Tulak Horde in the Valley of the Dark Lords, and bring me the shards from each of the ruined shrines.
I have need of you, young one. Whatever errand your master sent you on can wait until we are through.
My master would smite you for your impudence.
Then your master is a fool. I am Inquisitor Urinth, and I represent the intelligence operations of the Sith. We are currently holding an important Jedi prisoner. A spy who attempted to reach this academy. We have plans for him. Upon capture, we found the Jedi's mind simple to manipulate. We fed him false memories through a combination of drugs and sorcery. Soon he will return to his Jedi commanders and report the lies we fed him. He will know nothing of what we've done. All that remains is to stage his escape.
And once he's free, what will he tell the Jedi? What did you plant on him?
Information that should encourage certain Outer Rim colonies to reduce their defenses. Once that happens, we can arrange the destruction of those colonies and their Jedi defenders. You are young enough, new enough, to be a plausible traitor. You will go to the Jedi, talk to him, do as he asks, earn his trust. When that is done, set him free. Do whatever is necessary to get him out of prison. We will ensure that he reaches his ship and returns safely to his Jedi friends.
I will accomplish it.
You will find the Jedi Quarian Dorjis in the jail cells. He is still confused and should not be overly difficult to convince.
There is no emotion. There is peace. There is no ignorance. There is knowledge. The Jedi Code will guide me.
I take it you're the Jedi who was captured.
I'm Quarian Dorjis. I'm a Jedi. Even here. Even on Korriban. Why do you care? Why are you here?
You deserve a chance to fight for your freedom.
And you're going to get...
I'm here to get you home, if you play your cards right.
And I'm to trust you, the word of a Sith. I don't understand. You're here to help me. Why am I talking in circles? What's wrong with me?
The Inquisitors are messing with your mind. They pumped you full of drugs.
I suspected as much. It's so hard to think straight. There's no passion. There's serenity. There's no chaos. There's harmony. The Jedi Code will guide me. I can focus. If you want to help me escape, I'll need my belongings, my lightsaber, my comlink. Before I was captured, the Sith chased me into the tomb of Tulak Horde. I hid my belongings inside an urn to light my load. That is where you'll need to go.
Acolyte, I come with a message. Lord Barriss can teach you the secrets of the Sith, but not all of the skills. For that, there are specialists in the Academy. Lord Barriss commands you to find them and improve your skills.
The pure blood in your veins gives you a very attractive coloring.
To even touch a pure blood woman, you must prove that the Sith runs strong through your muddied veins. A Sith woman only respects power. Go. Someday you may learn enough to impress me. If not, kill me. You will find the best trainers in the Academy's archive. You are expected there shortly.
Acolyte, the wind outside has torn my ears to tatters, and my eyes grow strained. I've studied this tomb for years, slept on its stones, and dreamed of its depths. Now, I need assistance to solve its final mystery.
I don't dig through dirt for scholars.
Then you misunderstand the chance I am offering. This tomb is the final resting place of Tulak Horde. But he built his maze to hold more than just his body. He built it to secure his greatest creation, his terrible machine, the Red Engine.
Keep going. What Red Engine?
The machine was his life's work,
A perfect puzzle that hid all his secrets. It was a vault and a library all at once. The scholars in the academy, they say the red engine was never completed. They say it never functioned. But I know how it works, and I know how to fuel it.
Then why not inform the scholars?
They think that I, not a Sith, nor an educated man, couldn't discover the truth. They ignore my findings and are blinded by arrogance. Listen now. Anyone can activate the red engine, but unless it receives its sacrifice, it will only sputter and die. The machine needs blood and hatred to become fully operational. If a Sith could slay the tomb's beast in its presence, their deaths would be its fuel. Find the machine within the tomb. Work its mechanisms. And when at last it reveals Tulak Horde's secrets, I beg of you, bring me its scripture.
Step forward. I assume you've completed my task. I will take the holocron now. It is time we judge the purity of your overseer's blood. Time we know how much of the ancients survive in their veins.
What does it matter? The ancient Sith are dead.
It matters because the ancient Sith are the source of our power. They are everything we are. The holocron, it glows white. So little Sith blood in all of the Academy. And only one of the Overseers wears the red marks. This is shameful. I will bring this to the attention of the Dark Council. Measures must be taken if the true Sith are to survive.
Sith blood may disappear, but Sith teachings will endure.
They are one and the same. You have served well. It is too late for me to alter your training. But in the future, perhaps acolytes will kneel at the feet of the pure-blooded.
I know you. We talked before. My head's clearer now, Sith. It's all here. The comlink, my lightsaber, everything I hid. You're going through with it. With all this, once the guards change shifts, I think I can slip out of the academy. But what about you? Will you be okay?
Me? I'll be fine. I'm more worried about you.
I know you. So with
Korriban is my home, Jedi filth. I fear nothing here.
I should have remembered that. I apologize for my concern. I still don't understand why you're doing this, but I thank you.
I think it's time that I be going.
As you say, Sith. Thank you again. I'm sorry the Empire took you in instead of the Jedi. If things had been different, maybe you could have been part of the Order.
So the Jedi is preparing his escape. You did well. Not perfectly, but I have confidence the operation will succeed. Our business is concluded. I will make note of your assistance in my report.
Anything for a fellow Sith.
As it should be. Take these tokens as payment for your service, and know that no Jedi can threaten Korriban. Now go.
Approach. I've heard rumors of your exploits in the tombs. You follow in the footsteps of failed apprentices, ones sent to slay renegades and crack the shells of armored droids. You fared better.
You see it correctly.
The mining droids not only protected the slaves who subverted their program, but threatened to damage the tombs of the ancients. That would have been unforgivable. And for succeeding where others died,
You will be rewarded.
You did it, didn't you? You got the shards from the tomb, and you're on your way back to Lord Barriss.
Are you here to congratulate me?
I'll take that as a yes. Stop! I'm sorry. I made a mistake. I tried to get through the tomb, but there were just too many Chirac. I barely escaped. I figured better to ambush you and take your shards. But I see that's just as futile. Vemran is already inside with Barriss. All the other acolytes died. You were my only chance. Now, I'm doomed. I'll never become Sith. Unless I return with the shards, Barriss will have me killed.
I'll save Barriss the trouble of listening to your whimpering. Die!
Supplicant returns, and with all the shards from the tomb of Tulak Horde. Superb. It seems your hopes have been dashed, Vemran.
Appearances can be deceptive.
Excuse Vemran, Supplicant. He didn't take kindly to you turning those young acolytes on him, even though they were only untrained novices.
He should thank me, novices or not. I bet he had his hands full.
The tension is thick between you two. A great source of emotion to feed on. I wonder what will happen when it boils over. You both stand on the precipice of becoming Sith. But only one of you will have the opportunity to claim a special lightsaber and serve as my apprentice. I thought it would be you, Vemran, but I've changed my mind.
What? I've done everything you've asked. Better than any of the others. The honor should be mine.
This is as it should be. Get used to being in my shadow.
Today, Vemran is every bit your equal. But the Force is stronger with you, Acolyte. And there is a power sleeping within you. It was a simple decision. Now, Vemran, go wait in my antechamber for your instructions. This instant. Now I hope you fathom how fortunate you are to be singled out. If you become my apprentice, the galaxy will bend before you.
You honor me.
The lightsaber you will seek is all...
What?
I can't wait to start killing. You're not going to regret this, Barriss. I was born to be Sith.
The lightsaber you will seek is old and powerful. It is housed in a forbidden cavern in the tomb of Nargassadow, where few Sith have ever set foot. Almost no one knows how to find the secret entrance. But there is a Twi'lek in the holding pens who was caught breaking in there. I hear she is quite willful. Take her and make her show you the entrance to the Forbidden Cave.
I will take care of that.
Other acolytes seeking to complete their trials are sent to the tomb, where Academy laws are waived. They will try to murder you. This test will determine if you become Sith. So bolster yourself. To set foot in the tomb of Nargassadow is to breathe in death itself.
Ouch! Give it a rest, will ya?
I'm getting my fill of fun while I still can, slave. As if on cue, look who's back. Word is you might become Lord Barriss's apprentice. Nice work if you can get it. So, I hear you'll be relieving me of this Twi'lek. She's a pain in the neck.
Ha! Who's a pain in the neck? I'm the one wearing a shock collar.
Consider that a going-away present, Twi'lek. Seems you might be useful for something after all. This bruiser is taking you into the tomb where we caught you.
None of you can figure out how to activate the tomb statues to open the Forbidden Cavern, huh? You got some kind of business in that secret Sith chamber, do you?
Yes, and I'd appreciate your help.
Don't bother being pleasant. Here, kid, take the shock control color. I'll set it to a high level.
None of you. You got some kind...
My business is none of yours.
Here, kid, take the shock control color. I'll set it to a high level. Use it enough, she'll show you the back door to her mother's house.
I suppose I can play tomb tour guide. A lot of work went into cracking that nut, but I did it once. I can do it again. So we're clear. I'm officially on strike when it comes to domestic duties.
You'll do everything I require, and I mean everything.
Don't get any twisted ideas in that Sithy head of yours. Lead the way. I'll show you the unlocking points throughout the tomb, and then open the secret door for you.
Light, may I speak to you for a moment?
I'm always willing to listen to a beautiful woman.
Oh, yes. Thank you. You're too kind, really. There was another acolyte, not long ago, who entered this tomb and did not come back. He died in there.
And you were worried to see a handsome man like me die too?
No, I mean, not that... But that's not what I meant. I mean, it's just that the acolyte who went in there, he was a good sort, friendly and talkative. He said he was entering the tomb to prove himself to his father. I just thought it would be nice if somebody took his body back and told his father he didn't make it.
Yes, the father should be told that his son has fallen.
I'd never survive in there. And even if I did, I wouldn't be allowed to see his father. He is a Dark Honor Guard stationed in the Academy. None but Sith can ever set foot on the sacred ground where he stands watch. But you could find the body and bring it to his father. Please do this and honor the fallen.
If I see the Acolyte's body, I will try to retrieve it.
Thank you so much. If you find the Acolyte's remains inside the tomb, let me know. I can tell you where to find his father in the Academy.
Who wrecked you stand exactly? Koslejike, you might have been, yes?
What are you supposed to be?
Dwarf.
I'm an Acolyte now, but I'll be Sith soon.
Come, yes. Let's just get her fresh. And
why don't you start from the beginning? I'm an acolyte now.
Yes.
We were never alike. I'm the pride of the Academy. What do you mean, stronger? If Prythor's the one who exiled you to these caves, I doubt he'll change his mind about feeding you. There is strength and power within you. I'd like to know the source.
Yes, let's get her fresh and
Hey, this is it. The secret entrance to the hidden cavern is in here. Just let me get my bearings.
Take your time, slave. Just have the entrance uncovered by the time I've finished killing your new master.
Can't say I'm surprised to see you, Vemrin. You're remarkably predictable.
My passions run deeper than yours. I am the true essence of what it is to be Sith. My legacy has suffered long enough. After today, you will be forgotten. It ends here and now. Barry.
Ares's apprentice was my destiny. Did I come this far and overcome such adversity, only to be proven unworthy?
I have waited a long time to put you in your place. Consider this. Killing you was easy.
Then do it. Finish me.
Wow. Nice work.
Just find the Forbidden Cavern.
I already have. See? The secret entrance is right here. You're welcome.
You have been most helpful.
It's nice to be acknowledged. Thanks.
Got torn up pretty badly in there.
He was so brave and ready to prove himself to his father. His father was Naaman Fall. As I said before, he's one of the Dark Honor Guards in the Academy. If you take the Acolyte's remains to his father, I'm sure he'll be grateful.
That sounds worthwhile.
Thank you. It's good to see that there are more feelings embraced by the Sith than just hate and fury. You can find the Acolyte's father outside the chamber of the Dark Council. That's where he stands guard.
I'm training slaves to feed the beasts, and I don't have time to chat.
Have you heard of a creature called Serun?
Serun? You know of Serun? That creature was close to me when I was an Acolyte.
It helped me survive my trials. It traveled places I couldn't, told me everything it heard and saw. It had been living off vermin before I came along. I figured out a way to make it healthier, stronger. Seyrun's special meals.
What is Seyrun exactly? I've never seen anything like it.
Its people come from the planet Biss, but it's lived on Korriban as long as anyone can remember. Seyrun never knew exactly what I fed it. Its meals weren't just beast fodder. Seyrun ate the corpses of the Academy's failures, feeding on their energy after death. It grew exponentially more powerful with every meal, and became strong in the dark side.
That has fiasco written all over it.
Pity I didn't have your insight at the time. When I saw how twisted Seyrun was becoming, I sent it away. It was becoming hungrier all the time, and I feared it would attack the living. Destroying it seemed impossible. It could heal any injury it suffered. I hoped it would find a new home somewhere, but it seems we must act more decisively.
What exactly is your plan?
Aid Seyrun and it will turn on us. One more taste of power and it will begin hunting acolytes. I can't allow that. Together, we must poison Seyrun. Before I sent Seyrun away, I developed a powerful toxin, but I didn't have the heart to use it. It won't kill the creature, but it should strip it of its power.
So let's say we poison it. What happens to Seyrun then?
My best guess? If we do this, Seyrun won't survive much longer. It will hide as best it can and slowly starve. But the alternative is to let it become a living horror.
Then let's poison that thing.
I'm glad you see it as I do. I'm giving you this meat. Don't ask me where it came from, but it should fool Seyrun. Once the poison is in its system, it will weaken. I take no satisfaction in this. But it is necessary.
You don't belong here. You stand before the Chamber of the Dark Council, and this floor is off limits to all who are not Lords of the Sith. If you are not on official business, you will leave now.
I've come with news about your son.
So that is the smell you carry. It is said he went into the tomb of Naga Sadao. He was such a weak boy. He shames me in death as he shamed me in life. When I heard of his death, I could not leave my post. Honor forbade it. Still, I would like to know what happened in there.
Of course. Ask away, my lord.
Your deference does you credit. Now tell me, where did you find his body? Did my pathetic son even make it past the first steps? In the end, was he Sith?
He died valiantly, deep in the tombs. He was nearly Sith.
He died well. I suppose my son had more of me in his heart than I had ever considered possible. With this news, you have brought me a peace I didn't think possible. Thank you. I will have him buried in honor. Take this small token of my appreciation and go.
Was a staunch traditionalist, and he was especially hard on me. But he's my blood. Did you think you could kill him and get away with it?
Refresh my memory. I kill many people's fathers.
You seek to add insult to injury? I'm Eskla Greiton. My father was Overseer Tremel. Remember killing him?
My business is none of yours.
My business is vengeance. You! My father...
Who told you I killed your father?
Everybody says so. The whole place knows you killed him. And now you have to die.
Well, I suppose the whole place can't be wrong.
You'll rue the day you took his life. Attack! You! My father...
Who told... Stand down, Eskella. Your father isn't dead.
That's a lie. Lord Barriss has his hand.
I mercifully took your father's hand instead of his life.
What? You took pity on him and now he pretends to be dead? You may not be a murderer, but your mercy proves you're not Sith material either. I should inform Lord Barriss, but I won't. No, let him discover your softness for himself. My directive is clear now. I must hunt down my gutless father and end his humiliation.
I'm not going to let you do that.
Let me? Who do you think you are? My father has brought shame to me and our entire family. He must die. Never mind, I'm killing you anyway. Men?
You think you scare me?
I am beside myself. Not only did you get the Twi'lek to cooperate, but you completed the task and claimed the ancient lightsaber. Venran was not in my chamber, as I instructed. I take it he sought to stop you and claim the ancient weapon as his own.
He tried and failed. Venran was nothing if not consistent.
Bravo! I see you may indeed become one of the strongest Sith in the galaxy. Your trials are over. You are now my apprentice.
I am your humble servant, Master. I bow before you.
Rise, my apprentice. This is only the beginning. With you as my right hand, we shall strike fear into the Empire's enemies. I must convene with the Emperor and inform him of your progress. This shuttle pass will take you to Dromund Kos. Meet me at the Citadel there.
As fond as I am of this unyielding planet, it will be a pleasure to leave.
I am beside...
I can hardly wait to start, my master.
Good. Because it's time to unleash you. This is only the beginning. I must
tell the Emperor I said hello.
I'm sure he'll be thrilled. Take the Twi'lek slave as my gift. Do with her as you wish. If she'll be of use, by all means take her with you to Dromund Kos.
You won't have any complaints. Something to put you down. You're a sick creature, Serun. I'm not letting you run free. Leave this evil place, Serun. Leave the academy and leave... You won't have something to put. Our paths shall never cross again.
Let's take a socas. Hold your magnet.
Ogeo, haz que el ente te socaltó. A Jorgone Yoltard, el Inbult Hatrafel es Leult Kos. A Jorgone Yoltard, el Inbult Hatrafel es Leult Kos. Aten Germindig, huye Anas.
So, hey, I've been thinking, maybe you want to take this shock collar off? You know, as a sign of thanks for my hard work on Korriban. Not that I don't enjoy the perpetual fear of electrocution.
You will do as I say and not ask for favors.
Yeah, that's a real keen idea and all, but what do I get out of it?
That's a point. Behave and later, the collar.
You're serious? All right, I can do that. I think. Behave, Vet. Nobody better mess with us now.
Mirpama Kupka, Kramanik, Umlu Kiga Mayamak, Mulak Apajam Kamga, Amka Nemnang, Ampa Nemnang Memua Inok, Omogala Apayang, Nelama Imi Amka Amga.
As it should be.
Nanikari Maraka Amka, Jakuk Libik, Memarakneba, Karahika.
Tell the captain that I'll be back on the bridge as soon as I've done his errand.
Yes, sir.
Good to have you aboard. I'm Lieutenant Silas, second in command of the Black Talon. We're your ride to Drummond Cass.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Yes, sir.
Good to have you aboard. I'm Lieutenant Silas, second in command of the Black Talon. We're your ride to Drummond Cass.
I'm sure the ship will suffice. How long until we reach the planet?
Shouldn't be more than a day. The Black Talon makes this run on a regular basis without much trouble. We're primarily a transport. I should also add on behalf of everyone, it's an honor to service the Sith and the Korriban Academy. Consider yourself our guest.
Your respect for the Sith is admirable, Lieutenant.
Thank you, my lord. I'm the Empire's loyal servant. I won't keep you further. When we arrive in the Drummond system, I'll have you informed. In the meantime, your droid's in the conference room. We picked it up with the upgrades from Geonosis. When we docked here, it mentioned your name.
You have confused me with someone else.
Oh? The machine asked for you, so I assumed you were the owner. My mistake. In any case, it seems someone wants to get in touch. The conference room is down the hall. I'll be on the bridge. And you, soldier, when you're done playing honor guard, get back to your post. This isn't a luxury yacht.
Yes, sir.
Identity confirmed. Good day. I'm Advanced Protocol Unit NRO2. My functions are diplomacy, translation, manslaughter, and calumniation. I have an urgent message for you from my master. Please stand by for delivery.
Who's your master, and how does he know I'm here?
This is Unit NRO2 to Grand Moff Kilrin. You are now in contact with the Black Talon.
Well, sir, I am. And it seems you brought me just the person I've been looking for. My name is Rikus Kilrin. I'm commander of the 5th Fleet, second to the Minister of War, and my personal favorite, the so-called Butcher of Coruscant.
I don't understand. What's going on here?
It's apparent I need another pair of hands. So I asked NR2 to check the ship's passenger manifest.
My good fortune that I was in a position to contact you. I was already aboard the Black Talon.
6 hours ago, the Republic engaged in an illegal border skirmish on the edges of Imperial territory. One enemy warship escaped. That warship, the Brentel Star, is carrying a passenger of vital strategic importance. Yours is the only vessel placed to intercept.
This passenger the Brentel Star is carrying, who is it?
The warship's passenger is codenamed the General. We don't know his identity, but the Republic believes he possesses military secrets, our military secret. I trust the reports. The general must be captured or killed. Captain Orzik, the man commanding your transport, doesn't share my enthusiasm. He's disobeyed my orders to attack. Feel free to show him what the Empire does to cowards. Then commandeer his ship, find the Brentel Star, and deal with the general.
Sounds like a good opportunity for
I get it.
You have my attention. You speak to the apprentice of Darth Barriss. Explain this interruption.
6 hours ago, that warship...
This passenger...
The warship... I trust the... Feel free to...
Not exactly a simple request, you know.
This is not a simple age. Our millennia-old war against the Republic simmers while we engage in skirmishes and border disputes. Yet we cannot grow complacent. Traitors like your captain and threats like the general must be eliminated.
I will lead the way to the bridge. Once Captain Orzik is deposed and our hijacking is complete, we may proceed to the Brentol Star.
Please move aside immediately. Halt! My lord, this is a restricted... Halt! My lord, this is a restricted area. Captain Orzik's command. You'll have to leave immediately.
I suggest you back off before someone gets hurt.
I'm afraid I can't do that. This is the command deck entry hatch. No one's allowed in until we reach our destination.
Time is limited. We must proceed to the bridge immediately.
Our orders were to treat any approach as an attack. You need to take your droid and move it.
Your life is about to end.
Blasters out! Attack! Attack!
We must proceed to the bridge immediately. Marines have been neutralized. Scanning for additional threats.
What's going on? Sir, stay calm, Ensign. Everyone stay calm.
No threats found. The bridge is now secure.
Who makes the decisions around here?
I'm Captain Revenal Orzik. I'm pretty sure I know what this is about. For the record, I take complete responsibility for my actions.
Captain Orzik, I'm told you disobeyed a direct order from Grand Moff Kilrun.
Yes, I had no idea he'd respond this brutally. He must want the Brentel Star's passenger pretty badly. Maybe he just hates me. The Black Talon would be destroyed chasing a battleship. I've fought in the war before and I'll fight again, but I don't do suicide missions.
Suicide was deciding you could ignore your superiors.
The captain's dead! The captain's dead!
Shut up! You have our attention, my lord. What would you have us do?
Someone clean up this mess. We have business to take care of.
But what about the...
You have your instructions.
In accordance with Article 27A of the Imperial Code of Military Conduct, command of this vessel has been lawfully transferred. New orders are being downloaded to your consoles. Priority 1, intercept the Brentol Star.
Pukara, do as the droid says and prepare to jump to light speed.
Emerging from hyperspace now. One Thranta-class warship on the scanners. Powering up...
Enemy is firing. Turbo lasers, missiles, and what looks like transport pods. I'm not sure.
The pods are a distraction. Return fire. Aim for their power generators. So long as they're damaged and we're not, we have the advantage.
Lieutenant. Captain Silas, sir. Engineering is reporting blaster fire. They just cut out.
Continue the assault. I'll deal with this.
I'll notify security.
And don't worry. We won't let those Republic scum get away.
Damage reports from all decks. We're holding together, sir, but I don't know for how long.
Make sure it's long enough, Ensign. Your life and career are at stake.
Please stand alert. Grand Moff Gilran's representative has returned.
Congratulations, my lord. Security reports that the sabotage droids have been destroyed.
Bring me up to speed.
We've penetrated the Brentel Star's outer defenses. Their next assault won't come until we enter fighter range. Another minute, maybe two.
Transmission coming in. Long range. It's a message, but it's not from the Brentel Star.
Put it through, Ensign.
This is Jedi Grand Master Satil Shan hailing unidentified Imperial vessel. I'm en route to your location with 16 Republic vessels. I'm asking you to retreat before more lives are lost.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
I'm glad to hear a voice of reason. Let us end this conflict together. The Brentel Star is under my protection. Our convoy was ambushed and I sent the Star ahead. We will reunite. I just crippled 3 Imperial...
Damage from...
Disregard the transmission. Continue closing on the Brentel Star.
Understood. Maintaining course and speed.
The Brentel Star is under my protection. Our convoy was ambushed and I sent the Star ahead. We will reunite. I just crippled 3 Imperial dreadnoughts. I don't wish to destroy you. The peace between Republic and Empire is fragile enough already.
What about the stolen secrets aboard the Brentel Star? Is the General upholding the peace?
The General can speak for himself, but I believe he does work for peace. Incidents like this are happening across the galaxy, but only because we let them. Leave the Brentel Star to me. If you don't, then may the Force be with you. Because the men and women aboard that ship can hold you off until we arrive, and you will be defeated.
We'll see about that. End transmission.
Affirmative. Ending transmission.
Entering fighter range. The Brentel Star is launching its first squadron.
All right. Now we're close enough to fly in and send a raiding party. I assume you're going.
Whatever's necessary to finish this.
We'll be awaiting your successful return.
I advise that you proceed to the shuttle bay. The flight to the Brentel Star may be hazardous, but Grand Moff Gilran has complete faith in your abilities.
This is Protocol Unit NRO2. I hope you're receiving this message clearly, and that your flight was free of incident. Please hold for Security Coordinator Ensign Brukhara.
The Marines are on their way. They'll follow you in and hold each junction you secure. Try not to take too long. We're not a military ship. What you have is all you're getting.
Consider me warned.
This could be...
I'm not interested in excuses. If I need more Marines, you'll pick up a blaster yourself.
Yes, but... I understand.
I have been scanning the Brentel Star's communications, and security forces appear to be moving to protect the escape pods. It is extremely likely that the crew is attempting to evacuate the General. You must retrieve or eliminate him before he escapes.
We'll have the General before the crew knows what's happening.
Excellent news. I will be in contact if the situation changes. Proceed to assault all defense points between you and the target.
The escape pods aren't far now. You can make it on your own, General.
And what about you?
I will face my destiny. Go now, my friend. Halt where you are. I am Yavira Ban, Padawan of the Jedi Order. I was sent to protect the General, and you will not pass.
Isn't Padawan just another word for apprentice? You're not even a real Jedi.
I will be. I've assembled my lightsaber. My final trial is to face a Sith in combat. But I intend to drive you back, meter by meter if need be. Just as the Republic pushed the Sith Empire into the dark of the galaxy.
In case you hadn't noticed, the Empire is back, and we'll destroy you.
You cannot destroy us. No more than a shadow can destroy he who casts it. You may run, or you may stand your ground, but you'll go no farther. You aren't going to win this. I swear it. You aren't going to win this. I swear it.
Aside your weapons, I won't try to run. Besides, I doubt I'd make it to an escape pod without my intestines spilling out.
I take it you're the general. Grand Moff Kildren sent me to find you.
Kildren did? Of course. He would have the gall to send a transport to take on a warship and succeed. I was a general in the Imperial Military Service. Did they tell you that when they sent you here? Did they even know?
You were a servant of the Sith Empire. You should have been honored to obey.
If you knew what I knew, you'd understand. If you'd heard what both sides are plotting, you wouldn't be eager to restart this war. They're building doomsday weapons, shields that envelop planets, missiles that darken suns. Republic and Empire are planning to raise worlds. Annihilate civilizations. It will be unlike anything the galaxy's seen since the Great Hyperspace War. Then it's too late to stop it. The so-called peace is already lost.
I've heard enough of this.
Yes, I shouldn't expect you'd care. Well, you have me then. Me, my stomach full of blood, and my implant full of cybernetic secrets and stolen plans. What will you do?
I'm going to bring you to my ship. From there, you'll be transported to Dromund Kaas and taken into Imperial custody.
Where I'll be tortured or executed, or at best, placed in a cell for the rest of my life. Still, there's nowhere in the galaxy where I could truly hide. I will follow you.
This is Protocol Unit NRO2. If you are receiving this message, I urge you to return to the Black Talon as quickly as possible.
Explain yourself. What's going on?
There has been an incident aboard the bridge. Your tactics have inspired...
Idiots! You'll get us all damn well killed!
Thank you.
Welcome back. I'm pleased to see that you have returned whole. I do apologize for the condition of the bridge. As I'd intended to explain earlier, there was an incident.
There are corpses all over the floor. This is what you call an incident.
Several of the crew were extremely agitated by your behavior. Ensign Hetter feared you might execute anyone who failed to contribute to the mission. A group of officers attempted to free the ship before you returned. Lieutenant Silas objected, and a firefight broke out. There was a large number of casualties. But don't worry, I am fully capable of piloting the ship back to Drummond Cass.
You're telling me they panicked and killed one another?
That is correct. It was unexpected. Grand Moff Kilrin is eagerly awaiting your report. Shall I put him through?
Go ahead. There's no sense waiting.
Opening channel now.
Well, how fortunate I could reach my friends aboard the Black Talon. The droid's been keeping me appraised of your work, but I very much wanted to hear from you. How did the attack go?
The Brentel Star has been disabled and the General captured. He'll be in your hands soon.
Excellent. I'll let Korriban and Imperial Intelligence fight over him. You should be proud. This is only one of the many operations we're conducting across the galaxy. It's a new beginning to the war. The General was one of the greatest weapons the Republic had. A defector. And you've snatched him from enemy hands. I'll remember this. And I'll make sure you're rewarded.
It is an honor to strike a blow against our enemies.
You'll strike many more in the future, I'm certain. Darth Barriss will be pleased, but my words hardly matter. Soon you'll be joining us on the homeworld, and you can see for yourself what you've been fighting for. It should be inspiring. Enjoy the rest of your journey. Kilrin out.
You're the one, yes. Not like the scabs that exited the shuttle with you. You radiate power, Lord. I bow before you. I serve Lord Barriss. He sent me to meet his new apprentice, and I made sure I was here on time. I certainly did, yes indeed.
So, I'm met. Now what?
I'm just a slave who owes his every breath to the tolerance of Lord Barriss. He said to introduce you to Drummond Cass, and I take that seriously.
Get on with it. I don't have all day.
Ratu.
So, I'm met. Now what?
I'm just a slave who owes his every...
You have a strong survival instinct.
Thank you, kind lord. I am seldom referred to as strong. Lord Barriss ordered me to encourage you to explore Cass City before reporting to him. Imperials maintain the order, but they won't bother you. When you're ready, Lord Barriss will meet you in his personal chambers. You will tell Lord Barriss I was good? Yes? That I served well?
You did exactly what you were told.
You have my thanks, gentle juggernaut. I bow my head until you depart.
Wow, you showed remarkable restraint with him.
We're moving on. Keep up.
I'm Commander Rylan, my lord. I apologize for my abruptness, but I'm afraid I must request assistance with an emergency. Something is stirring up the jungle beasts, which makes the route between here and Cass City hazardous. Several individuals traveling on foot have disappeared.
Perhaps I could be of assistance.
Given the circumstances, I believe someone of your abilities is precisely what's needed. I dispatched two commando teams into the jungle to clear out the beasts, but they never returned. An emergency holo message came through from one of the team leaders. I'll play it for you.
Repeat. Landing beacons are emitting some kind of energy. Power surges are driving the beasts mad. Can't get close enough to reroute power. Lost my team. Beasts closing in. Need reinforced.
Sensors confirm unusual energy readings in the jungle. The spaceport's landing beacons appear to be the cause.
Just tell me where to go.
I'm deeply grateful for your assistance, my lord. The spaceport's landing beacons are scattered throughout the nearby jungle. You'll need to reroute power on all of them. I'll track your progress from here. Return when you're done. Good luck. The jungle predators are fierce.
Why are you blocking this road, soldier?
When the speeders were pulled off the line, people started braving the deeper jungle, trying to make it to Cass City on foot. Had a few deaths, some of them VIPs. Captain Tolto sent us to keep people out and poke around a bit, see what's out there.
It's nice to see the Empire protecting its citizens.
Yes. Some assignments are definitely better than others. We managed to take some data readings, even some holos. Big nasty critters out there, nothing to mess with. Our runner, unfortunately, is down a leg from the experience. If you're headed back towards the spaceport, could you give the observation disc to Captain Tolto?
I can and will. Keep up the good work, men.
Thank you.
I have a report for you, Captain. It seems there are monsters in the jungle.
Thank you, my lord. You do us all a great honor by taking notice of our problems. This is what I needed. I'll start moving to warn everyone off that path until we can get some full cleanup squads.
Mipunawa, Tuipitute Bak Batra, Wonga Wonga. Naka noya choski, noya kachuso kili, baklunki na atabu.
I do not understand you.
Mipunaka kili.
What would have to be done?
Naka noya choski, noya kachuso de mate chichoya, chubolo, awona kopotomte tak, maketiko uba kili, wata bunga dunko, putoga wata.
Danger only makes things more fun.
Kavaji uta kuga huta nupri da bumba wula mi umpi putamala bedwana nibo supuda nupajunki faguta ji uta vukise.
Sounds like a good opportunity for violence.
Chiholukuta chubu ikatsfu undole. Bafupa gi wanta humpa.
A second of your time, please. Mind a 20. Imperial intelligence.
What exactly is
A second of your time, please. Mind a 20.
You have confused me with someone else.
Not at all. Our files are very thorough. You're a new face on Droman Kaas. That presents a unique opportunity and a small window in which to use it. I need you to meet a man. Go where he says and do what he asks. There's little danger. But you must not question him.
I've never played spy before. Tell me where to go.
The man is named Manda, and he is in a local cantina. Tell him the Lord of Sorrow sent you. Good luck. We will not speak again.
Seven brutal bloody murders. Seven! And the killer is allowed to walk free. Decent, law-abiding citizens, loyal servants of the Emperor are being slaughtered. And what do our security forces do? Nothing. I've seen the killer myself, but the authorities say I don't have enough proof. I demand justice.
Why are you yelling at me?
I apologize for raising my voice, my lord, but these murders cannot go unpunished. Not when the killer is so obvious. Several days ago, I spotted a bounty hunter following people seemingly at random, but the descriptions of the murder victims exactly match the people the hunter was following. He's behind these brutal killings, I know it!
Only a coward kills defenseless people from the shadows.
And only a brave guardian like you can bring the coward to justice, my lord. I followed the killer this morning. Saw the filthy alien skulking into the Mandalorian enclave. Someone called him by name, Renegan. This bounty hunter must learn the Empire doesn't tolerate alien scum like him killing its citizens. He needs to be punished.
Manda, the Lord of Sorrow sent me.
Listen carefully. I can say this
Once, a Chiss security officer stands at the bank. Hand him this gambling chip. He will give you a small item and further instructions. Now walk away casually.
I have a gambling chip for you.
And I have a package for you. Do not open it. Better if you don't even look at it. There is an NK line droid. I'll show you where to find it. The package goes there. Long live the Emperor.
I have a package for you.
For me? How wonderful. And I, in turn, have something for you, to show appreciation. If we have not caught the Republic's attention with this sequence, they simply aren't paying attention. Empire forever.
I've got a shuttle to catch. You mind getting out of my way?
Fleeing the scene of your crimes, Rennegan.
Just my luck. 10 seconds later and I would have been off this blasted planet. You've been listening to Wrightson. Great. Listen, I didn't murder anybody. I was just hired to tag some random citizens, that's all.
You admit you're mixed up in these brutal murders, then?
No! I never touched any of those victims. My clients did all the killings. I was hired by a group of Sith to organize games for them. Didn't realize what that meant until bodies started piling up. When I confronted them, they laughed. Said Sith have a birthright to hunt lowlives. It's like a sport to them.
Tell me what happens now.
I'm not taking... No!
I'd rather face an armed and dangerous foe.
A battle without honor is no battle at all. Glad somebody still understands that. I'm in over my head, and too many people are watching me now. So I can't even leave. I need help, and I'm willing to pay for it. You interested?
Tell me what I can do for you.
I just want this problem to go away. And I only see two ways for that to happen. Either get rid of the loudmouth pointing fingers at me, or end that sick game the Sith are playing.
I think your clients need to find a new hobby.
Works for me. I'll have a plan that'll get them so good, no one will have to worry about fallout. Take this hunter tag. Use it on Sith acolytes all around the city. The acolytes will become my clients' new targets. Don't worry. I'll make sure they survive. Come back when you're done, and I'll pay you. My clients already ambushed one of the acolytes you tagged. Wish I could have been there. Attacking Sith is a major crime, even for other Sith. I sent the authorities an anonymous tip to watch the acolytes closely. When my clients jumped the ones you tagged, they were arrested and executed. Best work I've done in a long time.
Those murderers were not true Sith. They deserved death.
You won't hear me arguing. My loudmouth friend ought to shut up, now that the killers have been caught. That should make life easier. Here, take these credits. Couldn't have pulled this off without you. See you around, friend.
Not a minute too soon. Your timing is impeccable.
Did it just get considerably colder?
I see you decided to keep the slave. I hope she amuses you. I trust you've been acquainting yourself with your new environs. Did my minion point you in the right direction?
He's a dutiful servant who lives to serve you.
A properly beaten down slave is the only trustworthy creature in the galaxy. Your responsibilities will mandate contact with my various minions. Meet my directives, and you may do as you will to anyone you encounter, adversary or ally.
You can trust that I'll use good judgment, Master.
I have painstakingly built a vast network of spies and operatives embedded throughout the Sith, Republic, and Jedi alike. I have fingers, eyes, and ears everywhere.
You've successfully infiltrated the Jedi Order.
Yes, my operatives are completely undetected, and I wish to keep it that way.
His pointer finger was a bit twitchy.
A byproduct of constantly fearing for his life, but it keeps him in line, doing the trivial tasks that need tending to. Your responsibilities will mandate...
I work best when unrestrained.
A lightsaber can only achieve so much, apprentice. The most powerful weapon in a Sith Master's arsenal is information. I have painstakingly built a vast network of
Which am I to be? A finger, eye, or ear?
You're my enforcer. Deployed to protect my interests, intimidate my rivals, and destroy my enemies. It's time for your tenure to begin.
A military starship is touching down at the Kos City cargo port, delivering a vitally important prisoner to me. You will meet Commander Lankland at Docking Bay 12 and make sure he and his men successfully offload this prisoner.
If you're sending me, you must be expecting trouble.
We must always assume that we are being plotted against, especially when the stakes are high.
The importance of this prisoner cannot be overstated. Go to the cargo port now and stay sharp. You are dismissed.
All right, man, let's hurry up and get this hunk of carbonite to its owner.
Hey, Captain Olivius.
Boo.
Oh, I didn't see you enter. Lord Barriss didn't need to send a welcoming party.
You're lucky I'm not an enemy, or you'd all be dead.
Forgive me, my lord, but this is the capital world of the Empire. My men and I have performed much more dangerous duties for Lord Barriss. The prisoner is frozen in carbonite, so he's not a flight risk. And this is friendly territory. Surely we're safe here.
Sith interests are complicated.
Yes, my lord. Whatever you say. Let's get this oversized block of ice to your master.
Not so fast. My master ordered that block of ice. So step away from the carbonite man and no one ends up in a grave.
Your master is going to be disappointed.
Perhaps I didn't make myself plainly clear. I'm here to relieve you of your burden. Whether that includes your own lives as well is up to you.
Looky, looky. If it ain't Slestak, your master be wanting the froze man too, huh? Too bad for you, bit mine.
Too bad for both of you.
Ah, quite the popular trophy. The competition should be fierce.
If you not flee, you about to learn fierce, Slestak.
I'm such a fool. I'll never doubt Lord Barriss again. What do we do?
We kill them all.
I know you're Sith, stranger, but I think your bravado is ill-advised.
Me got ideas, Slestak. How about we play wishbone with the talker? Bigger half get the spoils.
A truce, then. You stood a chance against one set of us Sith, but even our master force user can't beat these odds.
Time to roll the dice, then. Attack!
Time for killing, boys!
What did I do?
I see more ambushes on the way. Maybe you can hold them off while my men and I make a run for it and deliver the prisoner to Lord Barriss.
I'll cover you. Go.
Come on, man. Double time.
Franklin informed me of the ambush at the cargo port. Apparently there are more eyes on us than even I thought.
I have felt a disturbance in the Force. It leaves doom imprinted on my dreams. A grave and mysterious threat that could bring down my entire power base. This frozen man is a top Republic agent captured while investigating my most deeply embedded spy on Nar Shaddaa. one of my invisibles. The Force grants me a vision of doom. And immediately, my untraceable spy, who has left no footprints, no trail, is almost exposed. It makes me furious.
It could just be a coincidence, Master.
It is not coincidence. I can feel it. A bit of...
Maybe your spy wasn't so invisible after all.
Do not presume to tell me my business. There's no profit in it. I must learn what tipped off the Republic agent. He is the key to uncovering the nature of this threat.
Now, while I thaw the prisoner and painfully siphon every morsel of information I can from him, I have some concerns that require your special talents.
Tell me what I must do.
No rest for the wicked, I guess.
Go to the Imperial post in the jungles outside the city. Commander Pritch is stationed there. He has a seek-and-destroy task for you.
I don't take orders from lackeys.
Pritch is merely relaying information, Apprentice. I must tend to the torturing of this miserable Republic agent. Lanklin and I have...
It could just be a coincidence, Master. I'd like to stay and watch the torture, my lord. I crave more action, so let's get on with it.
No rest for the...
Go to the Imperial post in the...
What will I be seeking and destroying?
Do not needlessly tax me. Commander Pritch will supply all the details. I must tend to the torturing of this miserable Republic agent.
Waste no time. I have more for you to do once this is complete. You are dismissed.
Exactly as reported. A degree 6 revolt, population equivalent to the Duros uprising on Xilior. Subjects occupy a moderate radius of jungle. Good. Good. Welcome, Apprentice. Your timing couldn't be better. I am Lord Drow. When the Empire encounters resistance on its conquered worlds, they call me. I'm here to end the slave uprising on Drummond Cass.
I wasn't aware there was a slave revolt going on.
Very soon there won't be. Situation is this. A Sith Lord was constructing a colossal statue of himself in the jungle. The Colossus remains unfinished and well-armed slaves now control the jungle. An embarrassment for the Empire, but an opportunity for me.
What can these renegade slaves possibly provide you?
Test subjects, of course. A means of perfecting my techniques. I'm testing a toxic weapon, a poison called Quell. Its victims experience a prolonged state of agonizing pain before finally dying. The victim's allies are so horrified by Quell's effects, they lose their wills to resist. At least that's what I intend to prove.
What a disturbing experiment. You're quite the sadist, Lord Drow.
Please, there's no need for flattery. I need someone to introduce a controlled amount of Quell into the slave's water supply, so that I can determine the proper dosage. Work is dangerous, there will be armed slaves everywhere, but your success will be well rewarded. What do you say?
Anything for a fellow Sith.
Superb. Then let's get started. My assistant, Sergeant Slerin, will recommend the correct dosage of Quell and give you a supply. See him at the research tent.
If I know Lord Drow's tastes, which unfortunately I do, he sent you for the Quell toxin.
I'm helping him put down the slave revolt.
Do you truly understand what he's asked you to do? What if I told you this experiment is pointless? That past studies have shown increased suffering has no impact on the speed of surrender. This has nothing to do with accelerating the end of a rebellion. Lord Drow simply takes perverse thrill in gratuitous suffering.
I'm sure Lord Drow wouldn't appreciate these comments.
Don't get me wrong, Lord Drow is very good at what he does, but he lets his personal bents impede our efficiency. I want this assignment over with. The faster this rebellion ends, the faster I'll be reassigned to more important work. Serving Lord Drow's bloodlust has stunted my career. If not for his inefficiency, I'd be a captain by now.
You'd still just be a meaningless Imperial drone.
Perhaps, but a better paid Imperial drone, with more authority. Lord Drow's dosage of quell toxin will have slaves writhing in agony for pointless weeks, during which this area will remain volatile. I've prepared a dose that will kill the slaves efficiently, which is better for the Empire and for me. Will you deliver my dosage instead?
Let's end this revolt efficiently and kill off these renegades.
Wonderful. It's the right thing for everyone. Well, almost everyone. I'll give you a maximum dose of quell toxin. Inject it into the slave camp's water filtration systems and see Lord Drow afterward.
I don't understand why it didn't work. I was meticulous with my measurements.
Those slaves must be more fragile than I thought. The quell you put in their water supply is killing them outright.
The shock of instant death will throw the slaves off balance.
Shock? I'm not interested in such brute force. All my research is now useless. Oh well. You did as I asked, and your payment was not contingent on the results. Here, take your credits and go. I have a great deal of thinking to do.
My lord? Look at them out there. They're like animals. Hundreds of slaves with no one to command them and without a thought in their minds as to what to do with their freedom. Like I said, the slaves are animals. But we've noticed strange behavior in the pack. And some of the slaves are killing each other. We don't know if they're mad or hungry, desperate, or if there's a faction of slaves who've turned on the rest.
I can see how a slave civil war would prove useful.
Exactly what the higher-ups are saying. That the killers could potentially be manipulated. We know that the killings are ritualistic. The murderous slaves come in the night, stab their foes, and paint themselves in blood. If you could investigate, catch them in the act and take them down, maybe you could find a clue to their motives.
Slaves will give up their knowledge to me.
Look for any slave who's turned on his peers. With luck, he'll lead us to answers.
Commander Bridge at your service, my lord. Lord Barriss informed me you'd be paying us a visit. I'm prepared to offer full assistance.
News travels fast.
Lord Barriss is nothing if not efficient. Let me follow his lead and bring you up to speed. There's been much unrest in these parts recently, my lord, capped off by a violent slave revolt that has the surrounding jungles overrun with armed slaves.
Then they're not slaves anymore, are they?
I stand corrected, my lord. Former slaves.
What no one knows is that Lord Barriss orchestrated the insurgents to disrupt one of his rivals, and he wants his involvement kept secret. Now the slave captains who led the revolt are threatening to expose Barriss's involvement unless they receive more potent weapons.
They must be killed.
That is in sync with my instructions. Commander Bridge at your...
News travels fast.
Lord Bisbee...
You can't deal with upstart slaves.
The slaves have been giving the forces sent to deal with them fits. I'm not part of that duty, my lord.
What no one knows is that Lord Barriss orchestrated the insurgents to destroy...
Now the slave captains who led the revolt are threatening to...
Slaves. They're never satisfied.
I'd just be happy if you took the stupid shock collar off.
I'll take it under advisement.
I see you know how to handle slaves, my lord. You think they know better than to blackmail a Sith Lord. Lord Barriss wants you to kill enough of the blackmailing slave captains to make the others lose their resolve.
Just tell me where to go.
Slaves are scattered throughout the area, but the captains tend to congregate near the unfinished Colossus. I'll wait here for your return.
Takes guts to sit here and wait, don't you think?
This is his post, Vet.
Pretty cushy, all I'm saying.
You. You're not the initiate. You. You are Sith. You honor us with your presence, mighty lord. Welcome to our prison.
What is this? Are you the one behind the killings?
I am Traka Unvor, leader of the Unchained. I am master of my hatred. When the other slaves broke free, I laughed. Like you, I knew their escape was a delusion, for only Sith possess true freedom.
Some elaboration is required.
I know the Sith code. Freedom comes through power, through victory. I saw a chance to prove myself. I culled weak from strong. I began to kill and to teach. I showed slaves freedom through bloodshed. Now my followers and I are the masters here. And soon, we will become Sith ourselves.
You may have potential, but are you strong in the Force?
My strength is in my fists, but the Force has guided me here. Now you can spread word of us to the Empire. Your strength is great. With your approval, we shall serve. Carry our message of allegiance to your masters, and we will become the new face of the Empire. We will be champions of the dark side.
The Empire will hear your message.
As it should be. Take this data pad, my plea to the Sith Lords. For now, I am not ready to leave the Colossus. With every kill, I feel my power grow. And there are many slaves who may yet join me. But soon, we will all be ready.
For now, continue your work. Kill the slaves in my name.
Farewell for now. We return to the shadows.
It's good to see you back. I knew those slaves couldn't hold their own against you. I take it you managed to track down one of the murderers. What's their story? Can we use them?
The killers will now serve the Empire. I have their oath of allegiance here.
What do you mean? Let me see that datapad. This is madness. They're serious. Slaves who think they can become Sith.
Those killers are closer to Sith than you'll ever be.
Yes, as you say. I'll inform Command. I'm not actually authorized to speak with Sith Lords on the blockade. But I'll make sure they know, too. It's been an honor working with you. I hope we meet again.
Ah, my lord, you've returned. I take it many slave captains have died this day.
They won't be bothering Lord Barriss anymore.
I shudder to imagine their fate. I must stay, my lord. It's been inspiring watching you work.
You've been very helpful, Commander.
Thank you, Lord. I'm pleased to hear that. I'll inform Lord Barriss that the situation has been handled.
I don't care what you do. Break my bones, burn my flesh. I'll tell you nothing.
I will not be denied.
Go spit, you monster!
I didn't know bodies could bend like that. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Spare yourself. You shouldn't have to see this.
Ah, apprentice, you've returned. Commander Pritch confirmed that the slaves have been silenced. Good. I'm still trying to extract the information I crave from this Republic agent. He's much more resilient than anticipated.
He'll crack, Master. I'm sure of it.
I will not rest until he does. I have another important task for you. It involves a renegade Sith Lord named Grathan, a particularly bothersome thorn in my side. Meet with my apprentice, Dreykul Ball. He's my covert operative in Gratham's compound. Ball claims to have made a key discovery.
I thought I might be your only apprentice. That makes Baal my rival.
Try to tolerate him long enough to get the details and conclude your business there. Gratham's presence is useful to me, so I don't want him killed, just crippled. Find out what Ball has discovered and do exactly as he instructs.
Today I cripple a Sith Lord.
Enjoy it. One day it won't seem so special. Now then, Republic wretch, where were we? Oh, yes. Tell me what I wish to know.
I used to be respected, you know. My word carried weight. One tiny mistake and suddenly no one trusts me. My troops were acting strangely, plotting something. Obviously, they were traitors. All the warning signs were there.
The smart move was to kill them all. How could I know they were planning a surprise party for my promotion?
You killed all the troops under your command?
I was under a lot of stress at the time. I've got my wits about me now. You have to listen to me. This time, I'm not being paranoid. This time, I've identified a major threat to Imperial security. There are Kubaz spies all over the jungle, and they're invisible. You can only see them when lightning flashes disrupt their stealth technology.
How can these alleged Kubaz make themselves invisible?
They must have powerful stealth field generators. If not for the electrical discharges in the atmosphere, I'd never have noticed them. The Empire's enemies are up to something. The Kubaz are here assessing our strengths and weaknesses for them. I just know it. Scour the jungle, watch the lightning flashes, and strike when you see a Kubaz. Kill the snouted scum and bring me proof.
Already you move through the Citadel as if it were yours. Perhaps someday it will be. I am the apprentice and voice of Darth Charnas. I speak in his name and I would bargain for your services.
I've never heard of any Darth Charnas.
My master prefers to remain in the shadows, but do not doubt his power, nor his ability to reward success. I speak for him. I require individuals capable of gaining prestige in a society weaned on secrecy and madness. Individuals who can earn respect, if not love. I need infiltrators to eliminate an enemy of the Sith. You would serve well.
What sort of enemy are you referring to?
Our enemy is the Order of Revan, a cult of fools hidden at every stratum of Imperial society. For years, the Revanite heretics have secretly recruited military officers, powerful Sith, wealthy mercenaries, anyone who can add to their power.
If they're secret, how do you know anything about them?
My master has spent many years learning of the Revanites. Together, we have exposed many. Instead of following the Emperor and his Dark Council, the Revanites follow a long-dead Sith Lord, tainted by Jedi ways. If you can uncover the Revanite leader's identity for us, my master will reveal him to the Dark Council. His destruction would be assured. All you have to do is join the cult. I can get you inside, but you must earn their trust.
I will earn more than their trust. I will earn their fear.
That may be enough. The Revanites have a secret compound in the jungle. Take this token to the cultist at the entrance. He will initiate you. Earn an audience with their leader. When you have seen his face, return here, and you shall have your reward.
Hold your position, please, and keep your weapon holstered. The remotes are scanning you now. You check out. Sorry, my lord. We're on the lookout for anyone with Lord Grathen. And I'm sick of letting him stomp on my people.
Some elaboration is required.
Look, stick around a minute. I don't know if you're familiar with the situation, but Grathen's a nightmare. The Sith Lord's gone rogue. He's holed up in his estate past the wall. He's got weapons, shields, and a cadre of scientists developing new tech to use against us. Grathen wants respect and authority from the Dark Council, so in true Sith fashion, he turned on his masters to prove his power. As a result, we have to put up with this lunacy. So if you're here to cause Grathen problems anyway, you might help us out.
I live to serve the Empire.
Here's the story. There are nearly 100 men assigned to this sector, some on the wall, some watching Grathen. 20 are missing. My men. Practically my kids. Grathen stole them, and I want them back.
Why would Lord Grathen be kidnapping soldiers?
I don't know what Lord Grathen wants with them. Maybe he's holding them hostage just to demoralize us. Who knows? But if you're heading to Grathen's grounds, help them get out. Tell them to report back to their Duchess. That's, what they call me.
Duchess? You'll have to explain that.
You try making it as an officer without getting tagged with a nickname. I've got reports saying that Grathen's been transporting prisoners to another wing of his estate. I don't know if it's my people he's moving, but it's worth checking out. Watch yourself. Grathen doesn't mess around.
What's the situation here?
This is Darth Malgus of the Expeditionary Fleet to all available forces. If you are receiving this, you have been judged an asset, and the Empire requires your strength. It is your privilege and your duty.
Not just my master, but the Empire turns to me.
The alien adversary Hegemony has established Hammer Station, a mobile battle platform that threatens our borders. You will join the strike team assembling at Vigan Space Dock to be briefed in full. In the name of the Emperor.
Do we know anything about this battle station or the Adversec Hegemony? What's the... I've never heard of a Darth Malgus. Do we know anything about this battle?
Did you lose your way in the jungle? You have mice, there's nothing for you here. And strangers are not welcome in this place. You'd best be going.
I'm not leaving. I'm here to join the Order of Revan.
I'm afraid I don't know what you're...
Ah, you do have the token.
Welcome to the Order of Revan, Initiate.
I'm looking for the Revanite leader. Am I talking to the right man?
No, this place is our haven. Built by the Master and protected by the faithful. This is where the Master guides us in the mysteries of Revan. The one who began a Jedi, but grew into a Sith, and then something more.
There's nothing greater than the Sith. Nothing more to achieve.
Is that right? The Sith are a path to power. But is the Sith philosophy where that path ends? As a Jedi, Revan was a warrior who slaughtered armies. As a Sith, Revan was a teacher who trained 1,000 dark apprentices. Eventually, Jedi and Sith both turned on Revan. But instead of being destroyed, Revan was reborn.
What do you mean, reborn? What was Revan's final fate?
Revan was stripped of power, stripped of life, of memory, and left to rot. And still, Revan relearned the ways of the Force. The reborn Revan destroyed Jedi and Sith, and came to Dromund Kaas. Although Revan's life ended here, the Master preserved that life, so that we may learn from it.
I don't believe this cult is just about learning.
We learn to be better, more powerful. Even though the Empire may not publicly support us, we believe in the Empire's ways. Revan mastered the light side and the dark side, war and peace. We seek to walk the same path. Take part in our rituals, learn Revan's path to greatness, succeed, and you earn the right to join us.
What do I have to do to meet the Master? I am eager to speak with him.
Around you, you'll find your new teachers, Revanites who have spent their lives recovering the works of Darth Revan. Speak to them. Complete the tasks you are given. When you are through, return to me.
Come here. Come closer. You are among the initiates who wish to join our order, and this is good. But tell me something. You are here because of the Order of Revan. Are you ready to die for us?
If that's what the Order requires.
So very eager, but not so very wise. Consider carefully. For every Revanite must face the trial of death, just as Revan died at the hands of the Jedi and Sith. Death freed Revan, left him unbound from all oaths and promises. It paved his road to rebirth. Will death free you from your past?
One way or another, I'm ready to find out.
Before us is a path. Beyond the path is a cave. A cave dedicated to Darth Revan. Initiates fall on the path. Initiates are torn apart by things inside the cave. But initiates who reach the end are reborn.
Tell me more of this.
Go, and you'll see. The path is here. The cave.
I comprehend what you mean.
Go. Free yourself from the life you've made. It will be terrible. It will be glorious.
Thank you.
you return. Dripping with the blood of the womb, you are reborn. Your old life, everything you were, all of it is dead.
You totally lost me.
In the cave, you died. Tell me how it feels. Your obligations have vanished. Your past no longer burdens you. How does it feel to see the world reborn?
It feels different. Just different.
So it should. You've done well. And I'm proud that you've begun your new life as a Revanite. Take this gift to guide you in your new life. It will remind you of what you've become. Leave now.
Come forward. Speak to me. We're all students of Darth Revan, and I enjoy the company of initiates.
I remember when I was like you. I remember my trials and the joy of killing in the Master's name. You're so fortunate.
How often does the Master ask that someone be killed?
The Master doesn't have to ask. He trusts me with that burden of judgment. I'm Ladra, once the personal assassin of a Sith Lord. I am now the serene protector of the Master and his students. I contemplate Revan's teachings as I execute intruders and heretics. But I also guide initiates and help determine their trials.
I am incredibly impressed.
Thank you. Your praise is kind, but unneeded.
Every Revanite's initiation includes a trial of the past, a rite to bind the initiate to Revan. Your rite will be very special. You will find the mask of Darth Revan, what he wore after becoming Sith. It's a powerful symbol of his greatness, long lost to us.
I have to do this to meet the Master.
Of course. The Master doesn't waste time with students. The mask is in a collection of antiquities possessed by my former teacher, the Sith Lord Grathan. It must be freed from that heretic, rescued in a rain of blood and death.
Why are you so interested in it?
I'll give it a place of honor here in the compound, of course, so every Revanite can see it. Speak to Torun, our curator. When your journey's done, bring the mask to me. Good luck.
What have we got here? I wasn't expecting a visit from any initiates, but you're welcome to stay and talk, in any case. I'm Torun, devoted servant of the Master and student of Revan. What can I do for you?
Ladra asked me to talk to you.
I should have known. I'm to ritually prepare you for finding Revan's mask, then. Ladra's devoted to the Revanites. She's also obsessed with that mask. Says it talks to her. Ladra wants the mask to represent everything Revan ever was, but he wasn't just Sith. Before his rebirth, he was both Sith and Jedi.
Whatever else Revan was, being a Sith is what led to greatness.
If you believe that, then why follow Revan at all? It's tempting to seek answers in material objects. Ladra will use the mask to teach that Revan was a being of only darkness. I don't want that mask becoming our order's sole focus. Bring it to me. I'll keep it safe among a few like-minded scholars.
Sounds like you'll benefit from this as well.
I'm not after the mask for myself. I have no use for it, except for what it represents. I'm sure Ladra promised a grand reward for the mask. I can't match it, but I can promise your initiation will proceed smoothly. Will you help me preserve the real Revan? Or will you let Ladra overshadow everything with a Sith relic?
I promised Ladra I would get her the mask.
I understand, but I hope you'll think this through. I don't have to tell you to be careful, but may the Force be with you.
Shh! I have to be very careful. Lord Grathan's eyes are everywhere. He's suspicious of all strangers. He must be blind to our doings.
Your name, now.
Captain Bryn, Imperial Special Forces. This work requires intense concentration, a special kind of mind. Grathan's trouble, see? Big trouble. Mad scientist type, likes work. My mission's to keep an eye on him, watch for anything suspicious.
I'm going to storm Lord Grathan's estate.
I figured as much. Sharp eyes, see? I can tell these sorts of things. I don't mean to be pushy, but since you're going that way, maybe you wouldn't mind helping me out.
I'm listening. What's your trouble?
See, my orders are to keep my distance and not enter Lord Grathan's place or cause any kind of ruckus. I'm supposed to see about a certain prototype turret design the Rogue Lord supposedly acquired. Empire wants it for mass production.
What's so special about this turret?
I don't know specifics, only that it's supposed to be pretty powerful. Lord Grathan's got the turrets hidden inside somewheres. I'd go looking for them myself, but orders are orders. I have to stay put. Since you're going in, you could maybe poke around and see if you can't find the plans to those turrets.
Now you'll see what a Sith is capable of.
Good deal. That's the spirit. The thing is, you never get past the turrets unless you take out a guard and get a security badge. The security badge transmits a signal that tells the turrets the badge holder is friendly. So the op is, get a security badge off a guard, find those turrets and grab the plans. Easy, right? I'll be keeping an eye out here, right where you found me.
Authorization. Authorization. System.
Please don't go! What's happening?
I'm here for the people Grathan kidnapped.
I am a soldier.
System cannot stop. Reassigning priorities. Operating number
21887. Please, did the Duchess send you? Please help me.
Your commander sent me to free you, and the others.
We failed. Failed to defend ourselves. Grathan's people took us prisoner for experiments. The scientists cut open our heads, put us in droids. Identification model OHK-99. They program us for advanced intelligence. Enhanced combat tactics. Now my body's lying dead across the room. I can see it.
Are the rest of the soldiers still alive?
I'm the last. The others have all been converted. They can't talk, can't disobey. But I know they can still think, feel. Please listen. You could disable us all. Send the shutdown command from our central command console. Please. You could put an end to this. Use the command console. I can't go with you, motor and combat systems non-functional. Please, make it stop hurting.
Intruder laying waste Lord Grathan's compound. I applaud you.
I'm Ismar Brengel, one of Lord Grathan's indentured scientists. I'd like to make your destruction of this place highly profitable.
You're happy I'm destroying Lord Grathan's compound?
Beyond happy, I'm practically giddy. 3 years ago, Lord Grathan lured me to work for him. He promised great opportunities, and instead I became a prisoner, slaving on freakish creations Grathan uses to advance himself. It's a thankless existence.
You must act on your hatred and kill Grathan.
Kill him? Don't be absurd. He's untouchable to someone like me. I'll have to settle for stealing from him. Grathan's cybernetics researchers, a sadistic bunch of scum, developed cyborg body parts that regenerate. The technology will revolutionize warfare. It's worth a fortune. I have a buyer looking to manufacture a cyborg army. You'll get 60% of my profits if you steal the cybernetic researchers' files.
For terms that generous, I think we can do business together.
Excellent! You won't be disappointed. There is a catch, of course. Grathan protects his computers with lethal security forces, war droids, cyborgs, even genetically engineered weapons. Expect heavy resistance.
I will destroy anything that crosses my path.
I have no doubt of that. Take this data spike. Insert it into the main console at Grathan's central lab. The spike will download all the data we need. When you're done, bring me the spike. I'll arrange its sale and transfer credit to your account.
You must be the operative Lord Barris sent. I thought he'd choose a stealthy assassin, not some senseless savage.
Watch who you're calling a savage.
You're not talking to one of Barris's imperial peons. I'll be working for Lord Barris long after you've worn out your welcome.
I don't have time for this nonsense.
You're right. We can pick up hating each other once the business here is complete. Now listen. Lord Grathan is a rogue Sith who boldly defies the Dark Council. Locked away here, he's been untouchable. Lord Barris wants to let Grathan know he can be reached. And after a year undercover, I've discovered the way. Lord Grathan has a son.
Maybe in another year you can find out his shoe size.
He wears boots, not shoes, smartmouth. I was assigned to find Grathan's weakness. He's kept his son a secret in order to protect him from his enemies. Grathan would be devastated if his only child and heir was dead. That would send a message.
Just tell me where he is. I will be the messenger.
You'll have to be more than a messenger. Grathan's kid is nearly 20 and strong with the Force. He's been trained in the ways of the Sith since birth. You'll have your hands full.
The tougher, the better.
Grathan's away on business. I managed to hack a special spike that will get you inside his private quarters. But first you're going to have to knock out Grathan's surveillance station so you aren't seen entering the quarters.
What do I care if I'm observed?
The surveillance system is also a sophisticated defense network. If you don't destroy the system before entering the private chambers, you'll never make it. All you have to do is locate the monitoring stations around the compound and, well, stick your lightsaber in them. Think you can handle that, brute?
Keep calling me names, Baal. You're playing with fire.
Is it so easy to get under your skin? That's all, then. Destroy the monitoring stations, then get inside Grathan's private quarters. The son's name is Beelzlit. Find him and end him. I'll meet you back here when you're done. Try not to screw up.
I kinda like his attitude.
Stop! You must not steal that precious data, I implore you. Were I not locked in Grathan's science dormitory, I'd face you in person. I can only hope the passion of my plea convinces you. I'm Lanitor Drogue, lead researcher of Lord Grathan's cybernetics division. That data you're stealing is my life's work.
You're another of Grathan's prisoners, right? How is this your life's work?
I'm no prisoner. I volunteered for this project because Grathan alone had the resources to help me achieve my goal. I'm the creator of Project ARC, Automatic Regenerating Cybernetics. I have developed mechanical body parts that grow and heal like actual flesh and bone. Making better soldiers is an obvious application, but my dream is to give these lifelike replacement limbs to the victims of war.
The more powerful our army, the faster the Republic falls.
What about the common Imperial citizens maimed by this war? Surely they matter as well. Lord Grathan encrypted my research notes to prevent duplication, but that data spike will download everything and erase the original. You're taking the only copy. Please don't steal that data. Allow me to continue healing the sick.
I was promised a lot of credits for this, and I plan to collect. You're another of Grathan. That sounds worthwhile.
You understand? Wonderful. Lord Grathan encrypted my research notes to prevent duplication. Please don't steal that data.
Healing the unfortunate is worth more than money.
Wonderful. You've restored my faith in others. Although we still have a problem. Unless they think you succeeded, whoever sent you will certainly try again. Download some other data from that console. Anything, it doesn't matter. Deliver the spike as you promised. By the time your contact realizes the truth, my real data will be safely secured elsewhere.
You're lucky I'm indulging you.
I'm thankful I caught you on a good day. Thank you again. Deliver the false data, and everything should be all right.
Thank you.
You've returned. The sounds of battle echoing through the compound was like music. Oh, don't leave me in suspense. Did you download the cybernetics data? Are we going to be rich?
It's all yours. Enjoy.
Finally! Oh, I've waited so long for this moment.
Everything is in place. I'll send the data spike to my contacts so they can extract and verify the data.
It'll be raining credits before you know it.
Enjoy your dreams while they last.
Oh, I intend to. Once my contacts authenticate the data, you'll see a sizable deposit of credits.
A disaster. Simply terrible. Somebody has to stop me. Somebody has to stop me right now.
Are you the one who's controlling these turrets?
I'm ashamed to say yes, but not by choice, I assure you. I'm programmed to understand over 100 languages and dialects, and in not one is the phrase on fire positive when referring to a person. Why, of all droids, I was chosen to maintain these awful things and protect their schematics, I will never understand. If only I didn't have this terrible restraining bolt restricting my actions. I'd destroy the plans to those turrets in an instant.
It's a good thing that restraining bolt's there.
I don't know how you can say such a thing. The turret schematics are stored within my databanks. If the restraining bolt was removed, I could delete them, ensuring that no more turrets could be built. It's the next best thing to disabling the turrets themselves. If you value organic life, you will remove my restraining bolt. And let me destroy the schematics once and for all.
I'm downloading the plans for the Imperials.
If you're insistent on it, there's nothing I can do. After all, I'm not programmed for combat. If it were up to me, organic species would not be allowed to do such horrible things to each other.
Not your choice to make.
No, I'm not programmed for war or violence at all. And furthermore, it's a good thing I don't have a stomach. Because watching Lord Grathan's test subjects burst into flames would be more than I could handle, I think.
Mother, a stranger approaches.
You don't know the half of it, kid.
I am Sylvanta Grathan. How dare you enter my son's room uninvited? Who are you?
Step aside, woman. I'm here for the boy.
You'll have to kill me first. And while my son is still an acolyte, I am fully Sith.
Then we have something in common, Sylvanta.
Then may the Force give me the strength to defeat you. Beelzlet, take cover.
No, Mother! I stand at your side! Attack!
Think you scare me?
Stop! You are more than a match for us. Mother, if I am the target, save yourself. I don't want to see you die.
My son, you must not sacrifice yourself for anyone, not even me. You must endure at all costs. Assassin, you've carved your way into the inner sanctum of Lord Grathan's compound, all to kill a boy. You are a breath away from the Master himself. Spare us, and I'll help you destroy Lord Grathen instead.
You want me to kill your husband? Aren't you the dutiful wife?
I married Lord Grathen for power. It was a means to an end. Now I want out. I'm strong, but can't touch my husband. How long I've waited for someone to end his oppressive rule.
Grathen must live.
And so he shall. Just hear me out. A wicked plan is taking shape. Long ago, my husband was nearly beheaded. Now he cannot exist without his helmeted mask. Everyone knows this. Kill Lord Grathen. My son will wear the mask and assume his mantle. He'll publicly rant that his son was murdered. No one will be the wiser.
What's in it for me?
In addition to appearing successful in your task, I'll reward you in either credits or an item of power. Your choice.
I prefer a powerful item.
Excellent. You won't regret it. Lord Grathen deserves to die. With this pass card, you may enter Lord Grathen's secret chamber. You'll find him there. After you've ended Lord Grathen's miserable existence, bring his masked helmet to me.
Be sure there are no surprises when I return.
I'm certainly not interested in angering someone as lethal as you. Besides, you're doing me a great service. Be wary of Lord Grathen. There are few as attuned to the dark side as he.
I don't think I like the sound of that.
My uninvited guest finally arrives. Your feelings betray you, youngster. I sensed your murderous intentions the moment you entered my sanctum. What's more, your unshielded mind has revealed your accomplice, my loving wife.
She sends her love?
Sylvanta is a user, child. She's obsessed with power. It's one of the things that attracted me to her, but it's outgrown its amusement. I am death itself, child. Come embrace the darkness.
Objective complete.
Sensed my husband's death. Lord Grathen is no more. What pleasure to think he suffered.
He got what he deserved.
Mother, what does this mean? Am I true?
Yes.
I took no pleasure in killing him.
Mother, what does this mean? Am I truly to become the master of this house?
Yes. I sensed my husband.
He didn't enjoy it. He screamed like a stuck calf hound.
Mother, what does this mean? Am I truly to become the master of this house?
You will wear his mask and assume his identity, but you are not yet ready to rule, my dear. The voice will be yours, but the words will be mine.
I have longed for my father's death and the chance to claim his power.
Yes, this is a great day. You have served us well, my new friend.
Perhaps you could show your appreciation in a more personal manner.
Aren't you the rogue? You freed me from an inconvenient husband and put me in control of this house. Let me show you my appreciation. In private.
Whoa! Wait a minute. You're not seriously considering this. You have really terrible taste in women.
Don't be such a child.
Age has nothing to do with good taste. But do what you have to.
Now that we've cleared that up, all this talk is making me impatient. Beelslid, find something to do, will you? Your mother needs some privacy.
Yes, Mother.
And are you going to dismiss your Twi'lek?
If you prefer.
Well, I certainly prefer. Don't strain yourself.
all the things I've endured to gain power, this was one of the least unpleasant. You are always welcome in my chamber, friend.
Keep the door unlocked.
Where would the fun be in that? Now leave me. I have much to do now that I control House Graffen.
I'm surprised you survived. So is it done? Is Graffen's son dead?
You're a condescending windbag, Baal.
It's pretty easy to push your buttons, Brute. Doesn't say much for Graffen's security forces if a clumsy clod like you was able to bang into his private chamber and off his son.
I find your empty chatter amusing.
You'll find my lightsaber a bit sobering. Killing the murderer of Graffen's son will solidify my cover here. Barriss can replace you easily.
Aren't you the scoundrel?
You don't know the half of it. I'm surprised you survived.
You're a condescending windbag, Baal.
It's pretty easy to push your buttons. Doesn't say much for Graffen's security forces if a clumsy clod like you was able to bang into his private chamber and off his son.
I find your empty chatter amusing.
You'll find my lightsaber a bit sobering. Killing the murderer of Graffen's son will solidify my cover here. Barriss can replace you easily.
Barriss will be needing a new spy. I'm going to enjoy killing you.
Though I'm more than capable of facing you alone, a smart man uses every advantage. And I am a smart man.
The intruder! The intruder is here! Everyone to me! Attack!
Treat, you're back. I take it you have the plans to the turrets, then? Can't wait to lay me eyes on them. Can't wait to take them back to the Empire.
It's all yours. Enjoy.
This is great news. These turrets are the future of Imperial anti-personnel weaponry, and Lord Graffen wanted to keep them all to himself. And we showed him. Can't wait to try these out on some Republic scum. Good work.
So, I guess I have to thank you for returning my soldiers. My soldiers who've been tormented and put in droid bodies. My soldiers whom I didn't even recognize at first. You brought them back to me.
They'll serve the Empire better than ever now.
They'll certainly be loyal, and they've sure got firepower, but that's secondary. They're missing their minds. They'll take orders, but they can't think like people anymore. Not your fault, I get that. Blast! But looking at those droids makes me sick.
I couldn't leave them under Graffen's control.
No, I suppose not. Best thing to hope for is that with time, they don't remember what's happened. Hope that their brains shut down completely. Blast it all. Anyway, you've earned your pay. You've made my superiors very happy. Those men.
They're lucky to be alive after all they've been through.
One way of looking at it, I guess. I'll see you around. And anyway, I need to contact these droids' families.
So, you have come. You who would join the Order of Revan. I am Moron Dokas, Lord of Beasts. I am Revanite, and I am Sith. What do you say to me?
Moron Dokas, I've come to prove myself worthy.
Very well. Then listen. For decades I have served the Master. He found me when I was a larva and saw that I was strong in the Force. Against the Empire's traditions he trained me. This is the way of Revan. To teach all species the path to power.
I comprehend your meaning.
Good. Now you will answer a question. And you will answer well, or face the claws of my pets. Why do you think Revan trained aliens in the ways of the Sith? Why did Revan offer power to all seekers?
Revan knew that servants are more useful when they're powerful.
You answer well. You answer wisely. You speak like a true Revanite. You may proceed on your pilgrimage and seek worth in the eyes of another.
Who should I be looking for?
A Revanite. A great warrior. Seek the mercenary called Setafar as she teaches her soldiers. Then shall your trial continue.
Tarkin, have some of the men head into the city. They've earned a break from training.
Yes, Commander.
It's good to see you alive. Not everyone makes it past Morin. Raymond contacted me from the base. Said you wanted to join our
It's true. I'm seeking the approval of the Inner Circle.
I'm called Setafar. I teach these mercenaries how to fight. Centuries ago, my clan fought Revan when we invaded the Republic with the rest of the Mandalorians. It was our privilege to battle Jedi. We lost the war over Malkor V, but that was a privilege too. It's out of respect for Revan that I agreed to join the Master.
I see what you're saying.
I serve the Order to ensure Revan's name isn't forgotten. Revan was a warrior, a leader, and deserves to be remembered. Since you're not bound by honor, how do I know you won't sully the Dark Lord's memory? What can you do for the Order in Revan's name?
I'll learn all I can about Revan's past.
Fine. The Order has enough warriors. You might be able to serve. You'll need to talk to one more person before you head back to the compound. Find Major Pathel. He oversees security on the wall.
I will be there soon.
Glory to Mandalore, and glory to our master.
Come on over. There's nothing to trouble us here, and we can speak freely. I'm Major Pathel, at your service. It's always wonderful to meet new initiates. The Order of Revan needs all the dedicated young people it can get.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
I don't know how your other meetings went, but I like to conduct these interviews informally. No point making your life difficult, eh? Quite a few initiates, young officers, acolytes and the like, think our secret society will help them become morphs or dark lords. You're not like that, I presume?
I need no help to claim my rightful place.
I didn't think so. Not every initiate realizes that advancement in the Revanites does not guarantee advancement in the Empire. Nor how dangerous being a Revanite really is. The Dark Council seeks to root us out. So, how do we respond? How do we answer the Empire's accusations of heresy?
We move secretly. We manipulate those in power.
Exactly. We work in the shadows to reform the Empire, but we don't betray its ideals. That's all I needed to make my judgment. I'm going to send a message to the compound. Raymond will be waiting for you.
I think it's time that I be going.
Journey safely, and be proud to be a part of the Order of Revan.
So you finished the pilgrimage. Not bad. I don't know what happened out there. It's none of my business, but the Inner Circle approves of your initiation.
I'm only interested in meeting the Master.
You're on your way. Take pride in that. You did good in this trial. Now you'll have to find someone else to show you the next stage of the journey.
Excellent. My initiation will be over soon.
Good luck. Every step brings you closer to the Master.
Well, you really made it, didn't you? I've been hearing a lot about your progress, hearing about your trials. Your initiation has not been an easy one, but you've met the challenge and showed you can walk Revan's path. Now you may undergo the final rite.
I appreciate the chance.
The Master will complete your lessons, and you'll be welcomed as a full member of the Order of Revan. This is a great privilege. The Master reveals himself to no one outside the Order.
I promise I won't abuse your trust.
You may go to the Master in his chamber. He'll be waiting for you. Listen to him, obey him. Through the Master, you will know the path of Revan.
You who have died and been reborn, stand before me now. You who have reclaimed the ancient past, stand before me now. You who have demonstrated power and wisdom to my followers,
Are you too afraid to show your face?
Silence! This is the end of your initiation and the beginning of your true journey. You will walk the path of Revan forevermore. The enemies of the Order will force you to move in shadows. But we shall keep your secret safe, as you shall keep ours.
The time for subterfuge is over. Know me for who I am.
I thought the Master was a man.
The ruse serves its purpose. Besides, it felt appropriate. Revan's own gender is unclear in many of our records. I apologize for the deception, and for not meeting you sooner. But you must know how badly the Dark Council wants me dead. The Order of Revan threatens everything the Dark Council prizes.
Why did you found the Order in the first place?
I stumbled upon the mysteries of Revan on Korriban when I became Sith. That started me down a terrible path. Revan came to Drummond Cass after being reborn. Some believe Revan died at the hands of our Emperor. I believe otherwise. I believe Revan overthrew the Emperor and has sat secretly on the throne for 3 centuries. Aside from our Order, only the Dark Council knows the truth.
You're completely mad, aren't you?
Could a madwoman have achieved so much power? Believe in me. Believe in the path of Revan. I have heard whispers in the Citadel. For decades, the Emperor has been in seclusion. The Dark Council no longer speaks with him. The only explanation is this. The Dark Council betrayed their leader and locked Emperor Revan away, seizing power for themselves. They seek to silence us because we know.
They want to silence you because they think you're heretics.
They do. But listing their many reasons for destroying us is pointless. My agents tell me that you met with a Sith named Sandor, a man who seeks to destroy the Revanites. End his threat. Go to Sandor and tell him that you met the Revanite leader. Tell him that the leader is his own master, Darth Charnas.
What makes you think I won't betray you instead?
You're one of us now. I put my trust in you. I obtained this Sith amulet from Charnas. Give it to Sandor. He'll believe you stole it from his master while among the Revanites. When this is done, though, when you've spoken to Sandor, you cannot return here.
Somehow, I'm not terribly disappointed.
Sandor must never suspect your true allegiance. You must walk the path of Revan on your own. The path to power. May the Force be with you. May it make you strong.
Tracking name targets.
Here now. What does she say, bring it up?
The master of the lightsaber returns. It must have taken great willpower to leave the Revanite cultists alive long enough to investigate them. Tell me now, did you find what we need? Did you see the face of the leader?
She's a Sith Lord, dark skin with black hair and tattoos.
I know her. I know her, yes! Tari Darkspanner. My master knows her. We will use her. The Dark Council will strip her of her power, her mind, and her life.
That seems logical.
I promised you a reward in the name of Darth Charnas, so you shall have it. You have served the Empire well. Thanks to you, we have the means to obliterate the Society of Heretics. The name of Revan will be spoken on Drummond Cass no more.
The Order was too weak to survive for long.
You speak truly. Leave me now. It is time to put Darth Charnas' plans into action.
I cannot break him!
Nice lungs you got there.
Mind your tongue, or I will cut it out.
Okay, I'm officially scared.
This is impossible. An unknown power must be shielding this man, which only confirms my suspicions. This Republic agent is the key to unlocking the threat we face. I must harness my rage and frustration. They will lead me to an answer.
Trust your feelings, Master.
The minion advises the Master. Very good. You demonstrate your progress. And the word has spread that Lord Grathen is incensed at the slaying of his secret son. I take it that was your handiwork?
After dealing with his son, I stayed to socialize with Lady Grathen. An added humiliation for him.
Ah, my young apprentice, you have just cheered me up. I haven't heard from Dreykul Ball, my agent in Grathen's camp. He's missed a scheduled communication. Let me guess. He gave you trouble, did he?
He gave me no trouble at all.
I can sense the truth behind your words, apprentice. Ball can be replaced. Now, back to my prisoner. There's one last possibility to break him. I thought it impossible, but perhaps there's a small chance you could pull it off. Over a millennium past, the Emperor claimed Drummond Kass and made the Dark Temple the epicenter of Dark Force energy. In the bowels of the temple, he conducted horrifying experiments that drained the knowledge and life essence from all the greatest Sith Lords of the time.
He destroyed his own lords.
They existed to serve their master, and that they did. He siphoned them to make himself immortal and all-knowing. The Emperor created a device called the Ravager that ate his victims' minds and delivered to him their greatest secrets. No one could withstand the Ravager's intrusion. Even the strongest Sith Lords of the Empire confessed whatever the Emperor craved.
Where can the Ravager be found?
The Emperor keeps the Ravager hidden in the Dark Temple, which has, in his absence, become a death trap. There's a good chance the horrors that await you will be too severe. But it's worth your life to me. The legends describe a secret chamber in the depths of the Dark Temple where the Ravager was encased. You'll know the device by its inscription. Be swift, apprentice.
Damn it, this would never have happened on my watch.
Ah, my lord. It's good to see that the Sith haven't let things slide. Not like the rest of this circus of an empire. First, it's slave rebellions in the jungle. Then this. We wouldn't have allowed these kinds of things 30 years ago.
What's the problem, officer?
I was sent to this construction site to investigate unusual behavior among the droids. I wasn't here long when one of the units attacked me. I barely escaped with my life. But worse than that, I found this transmitter on the droid.
Do you think the droids were being controlled by someone?
Yes. And I believe they're sending signals back as well. I warn my superiors what would happen if they continue to be lax about this planet's security. Someone, an independent interest, a rogue Sith Lord, is using these droids to broadcast Kass City's schematics to an off-planet location.
When I find whoever is behind this, they will learn what becomes of those who cross the Sith.
I hope you do. But with all respect, I think it's important that we stop the outgoing flow of information first. We need to get those transmitters. If we can remove enough of them from the droids, it'll make the data they're sending the sooner we get those transmitters out, the better. This information can't end up in the hands of our enemies. Back already? And you have the transmitters?
Just take them already.
Well, what do you know? And here I was starting to think efficiency had gone out of style. I owe you thanks. If you'll give me a moment, I'll upload the data to High Command and we'll see what's what. This is worse than I ever would have imagined. Lord Grathen's behind this. He has to be.
I need more specifics, not gibber.
Back already?
I know Lord Grathen and his wife, a scheming, troubled family.
He's covered his tracks well. We won't be able to prove it, but Lord Grathen has been sending security codes and planetary readouts off-world. Everything an invading army would need. Major Shellister is already en route to the probable invasion site with every soldier he can find. They'll meet you just across the bridge. Hurry.
Over the last 3 days, a series of transmissions left Drummond Kass and were received by ships orbiting a nearby asteroid. These transmissions contained safe landing coordinates for the planet's surface and security codes to bypass the orbital defenses.
Are we at war? Have the Jedi finally landed?
Even the Jedi don't have the temerity to attack Drummond Kaas itself. Several hours ago, small shuttles built to avoid sensor detection began to land and deliver troops to the planet's surface. These troops are brutal alien mercenaries of the exiled Lord Tytonus. Students of Sith politics will remember she was the rebel who declared her own kingdom on Bagheerin.
I thought that Captain Eisen said Grathan was behind this.
It may be that Lord Grathan gave her the information. But it's not his army landing. Lord Tytonus has judged her timing perfectly. With so many of our forces off-planet, it is possible she could take Kaas City if she lands her entire mercenary army. We must stop her shuttles from landing and beat back her forces. I've thrown every resource I have down there already. Now it...
Can you sense it, my lord? Something out there? I wish it were in my head, but I know it's real. Please excuse me. It's these long nights, excavating relics near the Dark Temple. My team uncovered several significant artifacts at a nearby dig.
Perhaps your team exhumed something.
They didn't report anything like that. Just the artifacts. Then the mysterious visitors. First, it was strange noises from the temple, then figures lurking nearby. Now they're days overdue, and I owe a report to Lord Duan. But I can't go out there. I need someone to find them, make sure the artifacts make it.
Those artifacts will be with the Empire soon.
Thank you. I was just about to write the whole dig off as a loss. My team's still in those caves. Whatever's happened, please bring those relics to Lord Duan. He's overseeing a small camp by the Dark Temple.
I've sent three separate expeditions into the Dark Temple. Not one has returned. I can't say for sure what's going on, but people who go in there, they don't come back.
How did you come up with that?
Sounds I heard coming out of that place would send a Rancor running, if it was smart enough to run. I've sent three separate... I can't say...
Show some respect to your betters.
Then you are everything I could have hoped for. You can survive the Dark Temple. I beg you to do me, and more importantly, the Empire, a favor. The expeditions I sent in were looking for specific data.
What kind of data was it?
We were studying a recent increase in seismic activity in the area. The slaves from the expeditions were equipped with data pads to store the data they collected. This information's vital to future construction on Drummond Kaas.
I wouldn't call it a challenge, but it seems straightforward.
Amazing. Fantastic. Your help is invaluable. I'll mark the location the expedition last signaled from on your map. It's the best I can do.
At last, the Dark Council has answered my petitions and sent a powerful fighting Sith to help secure the temple.
I'm not here to secure the temple.
Of course, I've been ignored again. How stupid of me. If you're here, however, you must have the authority to enter the Dark Temple. You could still save this planet.
You have my attention.
The Dark Temple is ancient, built during a previous incarnation of our Empire. 1,000 years ago, our own Emperor buried his enemies here. These enemies remain powerful, even in death, which is why the temple was sealed. But now, something terrible has happened.
Some idiot went and woke them up.
With the Emperor's attention elsewhere, a group of ambitious but ignorant Sith thought to gain power by raiding the temple. They didn't find the relics they sought. Instead, they awoke an ancient Sith Lord, Lord Kallig, and their expedition plunged into madness.
What was this expedition? How many people were lost?
At least 100. Several Sith, slaves, soldiers, experts. All stupid. Because Lord Kallig died by ambush, I believe he awakened unaware of his own death, and his expectations became reality for those around him. His power overwhelmed all inside the temple. And even now the workers plot wars against each other, believing themselves Sith lords, and drawing terrible power from Kallig himself.
Are there more dead Sith lords in there?
You begin to see the crisis. There are still more ancient Sith lords whose spirits lay dormant in the temple. If the ancient Sith Lords are woken by the violence within, they could overrun Dromund Kaas.
Let's keep them napping.
I have studied all of the burial chambers within. Each was made with the same ancient design, one we can exploit. If you fuse the 500-kilogram hinges on each tomb door, even a violent assault should not be able to wake the ancients.
What would have to be done?
The team I sent in earlier was using a massive metal torch. The torch must be recovered, and the doors of the ancients sealed. Do you dare approach the great Nilfenerus, Lord of the Sith, Master of the Undying Darkness? Answer me. What insolence brings you to this place, slave?
You don't look like a Sith Lord, and you wear a slave collar.
What? You're not afraid of me? You aren't a mindless puppet like the rest of them? I don't understand.
I still have my senses, but someone here is out of his.
You're right. I was out of my senses. But not anymore. I was part of an expedition sent by the Empire to measure strange activity in the Dark Temple. I became the mighty Lord Venerus, and the others became my obedient followers and servants.
Why don't you start from the beginning?
We were gathering data for the Empire, and then we were all suddenly possessed. It's strange that you seem to be unaffected. In fact, I thought the Imperials gave up sending people in here. What exactly are you doing here?
The Imperials want data. I'm going to get it for them.
So the Imperials haven't given up on getting their precious data, after all. This is lucky. You see, ever since I came to my senses, I've been worried that my followers will begin to doubt my leadership. I can't lose my power. I can't go back to being a slave. But maybe...
You have my attention.
All I ask is that you find the symbols of Lord Venerus' power. They were looted from his tomb by the people possessed by Venerus' enemies. The symbols will help me reinforce my followers' belief in me, lock them in their dream.
I'm making no promises.
Be careful. Venerus' old enemies will put up a good fight.
It's foolish of you to return here.
Uh-oh. Looks like we got another fight on our hands.
Those pieces you took from my minions belong to me. They will enable me to exact my revenge on Lord Farshal. I am Lord Vacuous, the conqueror of Begeron, the killer of Garatak the Singed. Return what you have stolen or burn.
Stand in my way and you are defying Lord Barriss.
I've never heard of a Lord Barriss. If you're name-dropping, you're doing a pitiful job of it. This is tiresome. You had your chance. Now die.
You think you scare me?
Enter and hear me. You mustn't kneel. I would gain no satisfaction from it. So you finally found our hidden temple. It's long since time. The followers of the Dark Path battle my forces, and your cruelty is needed.
This temple isn't exactly hidden. There's a path from Kaas City.
Do you mock me? No one finds this temple nor this planet by accident, nor without my approval, for I am Lord Farshal. I oversaw this temple's construction, and I have ruled the jungle ever since. Now you will serve me.
You look more like a workman than a Sith.
My robes and helm were won in battle against Lord Vacuous. My lightsaber burns with the light of a star, and you dare question me? Now do as I require, and the riches of the temple will be yours. The teachings of the Dark Path lured my apprentice and Yara away, but I will have her back. You will retrieve her from the temple depths.
How can anyone survive in the temple?
Whatever do you mean? Many live within the temple. It is our only sanctuary on this abominable world. I do not know how my rivals reached my apprentice, but I know where she went. The Dark Path hides near here. Kill the followers of the Dark Path. Fight your way to their altar, and Inyara must confront you. Do this, or be punished by my power.
I'm making no promises.
Then we shall see what becomes of you. The followers of the Dark Path are not far. Go.
Hello, stranger. My internal chronometer tells me it has been exactly 963 years since this hologram was made. Have the Sith truly lived in fear of me for so long?
Your name, now.
I am, or was, Kelleth Ur, a born Sith and follower of the Force. Like so many before me, I challenged the Emperor and was buried in this temple. Fortunately, I had just enough time to make this, an interactive image that would transmit my secrets to whomever was bold enough to find my tomb and unlock it.
Actually, I was trying to seal up this door for good.
Then it's true. The Sith still cower in fear of insignificant me. The way of the Sith lies in channeling the Force through the use of powerful emotions. Fear is the chief of these. The Sith feed on palpable dread.
What's the secret, then?
It's a lie. Fear is a lie. Passion, a lie. Fear gives temporary power, and passion is easily manipulated. Real strength in the Force comes when one is no longer afraid. And one can purge fear when one stops grasping. After power, after things, after life itself, and allows the Force to guide him. There is only the Force.
What do you mean, there's only the Force?
Just that. Everything there is, life and death alike, is wrapped up in the Force. What I learned only lives on through this image and its device. Yet I am one with the Force, eternal and at peace. Take them. Take my teachings to the Sith. They will find power there, but a different kind. Not of darkness, but light.
The world must know what you've learned.
Good. The Sith should know fear is not the only way. As for me, my message is concluded. I will now depart.
Stay back! I don't know you. You aren't of the Dark Path. You whispers to me... tells me to go back to Lord Farshall, that I belong to Farshall, but it's wrong. Something's wrong.
You must be Lord Farshall's apprentice. He sent me to find you.
Yes. No. No. I was someone else. Before I came to the temple, she keeps saying I'm an apprentice. Just an apprentice. And I hate her. But my hate isn't making me strong enough.
A true Sith's hatred gives infinite power.
Yes.
You're no longer in danger.
I came into the temple from the city. I remember the lights of the citadel, and then she pushed it all away. She says she's Anyara. She says we serve Farshall. She says there's no city out there, just jungle. Tell me who's right. Am I the temple apprentice Anyara, or is she lying? Is the city outside real?
Kaas City is real. It's where you're from. This temple is all wrong.
I knew it! Curse her! She's still in my head, but she's... she's my enemy, and I am Sith. I can defeat her. I will.
Now, can you tell me what's going on?
I came from Kaas City, like you. At the time, I'm not an apprentice. That workman, he isn't Lord Farshall. But we thought we were. We played the roles. We even had the power.
Were your friends here possessed too?
These people, they were slaves, archaeologists, all of them sent in from the city, all of them influenced. I don't know how long my mind will stay my own, so I need to leave here now.
Get moving then, and be careful.
I suggest you leave the temple quickly, before thoughts enter your head too.
Ah, my spies tell me you found the Dark Path. And it seems you survived their fury. Did you find Anyara? Did you see my apprentice there?
Anyara's not your apprentice. None of this is what you believe.
She is determined to remain with the Dark Path, then. How disappointing. Still, you struck a blow at my rivals. and the Dark Path will not move against me soon. You may leave with your life. Take this reward, a token in acknowledgement of your efforts, and go.
I still have questions for you, Lord Farshall.
Do not try my patience. Go from here now.
My network of spies reports that you crushed my enemies underfoot and found the symbols of power I requested.
We have a deal. I expect you to honor it.
I had not forgotten. I, too, have been very busy. Here is the data my servants collected before the temple transformed them. Let the Empire make of it what they will.
Enjoy your Empire while it lasts.
Actually, that reminds me. There's one last itty-bitty little thing you can do. You see, power is useless without subjects. So I'd be grateful. When you turn in the data, you'd encourage the Imperials to send more expeditions my way.
You're really every bit as conniving as the real thing. You know that?
Yes. I do think I've finally found my true calling. I can assure you, my gratitude, if you send more slaves to be my followers, will not be insubstantial. You're back. I hope you sealed the chambers of the ancients, Keleth Ur's chamber especially. I'm terrified to think what would happen if Keleth Ur and his crazed ideas were to reemerge.
Actually, I brought something from Keleth Ur here.
What? What's this? How could you? No, I want no part of this. Please destroy it. Bury it. Steal it away.
We can learn something from this and become powerful.
Clearly you don't understand. Throughout history, the light has endeavored to destroy the darkness. The Emperor was right to murder Keleth Ur for his heresy. Peace, serenity, words for the stifling of the very emotions that drive us.
Wouldn't it be wise to learn the teachings of our enemy?
No. That's not... Wait. Yes, I think I understand your reasoning. Fine. I will take the teachings of Keleth Ur and study them so that the darkness may prevail over the light. Now, please leave. The temple is safe, and I must take these teachings back to my chambers and make sure they're secure.
Your archaeologist team is dead. Killed for the relics they uncovered. I have them now.
Interesting. The Dark Temple's presence continues to surprise and fascinate. I'll quarantine the artifacts for future study. A shame we lost the whole team. At least it wasn't a total loss. After all, we got what we came for.
I'm pleased to have served.
Whatever secrets these pieces hide, we'll find them. Thank you.
The only thing more powerful than the Dark Temple. Any luck getting that data?
Here's your data, as promised.
Hey, you actually came through. Can't say I was expecting that. Can't say it's not a relief. Now we can finally stop sending expeditions in there, wasting all those slaves who should be building monuments to the Empire.
Slaves shouldn't be collecting data anyway.
My superiors may feel differently, but I tend to agree with you on that point. Anyway, I believe that concludes our business here. Goodbye, then, and thanks for the data.
When I sent you into the Dark Temple for the Ravager, I thought it might be the last time I saw you, apprentice. The prisoner grows weaker by the minute. There's no time to spare. Stand back and bear witness.
You're wasting your time. I will not.
Yes, the Ravager has seized his mind. Excellent. In his condition, we don't have long before the ordeal liquefies all brain matter.
Maybe he'll last longer if you reduce the pain.
The pain drives the device's effectiveness. Republic Worm, you have the information I desire. Tell me everything.
I am Republic Information Service on special assignment to verify possible Imperial spy on Nar Shaddaa, commissioned by Jedi Council, acting on suspicions provided by Master Nomen Kar.
Nomen Kar. That's a name I grow tired of hearing.
One of your enemies, I take it.
My oldest and most hated enemy. An old wound that continues to fester. Nomen Kar is a Jedi Master who infiltrated the Sith. I rooted him out. Then he nearly destroyed me and fled. He's dedicated himself to proving that the Sith have spies embedded within Republic and Jedi ranks. I've thwarted him at every turn, but he is tenacious. How did Nomen Kar come to suspect my spy on Nar Shaddaa? Tell me, Republic wretch, what alerted him?
Master, Nomen Kar has a new Padawan. She seems to know any beings. True nature, she senses hidden darkness and untapped purity.
Astonishing. I've never heard of the Force granting such a gift. Tell me, how does her power work?
All I know is when Master Nomen Kar brought her to Nar Shaddaa, this Padawan sensed darkness in your spy simply by seeing him.
This is a serious threat.
It is the doom I felt. The disruption in the Force. If this young Padawan can see through deception and disguise with such little effort, she threatens everything I have worked for. Continue, Republic dog.
Kar believes his Padawan's ability is foolproof. The Jedi Council is skeptical. I was to provide the proof, but I wasn't able to report my findings.
We must know more about this Padawan.
Yes, my apprentice. Such a threat must not wander the galaxy unchecked. Who is this Padawan, you Republic pest? Tell me everything you know about her.
She was found on Alderaan. Her power first emerged training on Tatooine. And Jedi sent another agent to investigate someone she suspected on Balmora.
It's fading. Is she human or one of the Jedi's cursed aliens? Where can I find her? What is her name? The Ravager has emptied his mind. That is all we have to go on. A few random places within the greater galaxy where Nomen Kar and his Padawan have been.
It's a start, Master. That device did the trick.
You are correct. We now have leads to follow. Nomen Kar is a relentless crusader. This Padawan and her unprecedented power threaten everything I have achieved. Your duties are likely to take you to the far reaches of the galaxy. I will need to deploy you at will. You shall have a starship of your own. You've earned it. Go to my personal hangar in the spaceport and claim it.
I'll head there immediately.
I must ponder our next move. Waste no time. Get your starship in my hangar and wait for further instructions.
Yeah, let's go before he tells me to clean all this up, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Take a look at that. We're going in style now.
Nice ship. Are you leaving Dromund Kaas?
You have something to say about that?
On the contrary, I have a going-away present for you. Sylventa Grathen sent me to deliver this token of her appreciation for all you've done for her. It will greatly enhance this new ship of yours.
Does she usually send a Sith to deliver a gift?
Very good. No, that's not the typical M.O. I'm here on behalf of Sylventa's husband, Lord Grathen, who has added his own present to the offering. He claims you know too much.
Sylventa needs to get her house in order.
Are you mad? Lady Grathen doesn't control the household. I answer only to Lord Grathen. I've murdered just about every form of sentient being in the galaxy, and I'm here for you.
RH, thy totem droid for this vessel. You must be my new master. Gentle, kind new master.
Do I seem gentle to you? Tell me your attack protocols, droid.
I was not constructed for violence, master. Greetings. I am 2VR8, thy totem droid for this vessel. You must be my new master. Gentle, kind new master.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. What's your function aboard my ship?
I am programmed for a wide array of tasks, including but not limited to meal preparation, ship maintenance, janitorial duty, and etiquette. Welcome aboard this Fury-class Imperial Interceptor, a versatile craft combining a starfighter's maneuverability with armament to rival larger military vessels. You'll find all of the standard amenities, including your own private captain's locker for storing valuables. The astrogation console contains a constantly updated map of the known galaxy. Interstellar communications are accessed via the ship's holoterminal. Priority alerts that you may find useful are available from the Imperial Holonet console. Lastly, the ship's intercom will inform your crew that you wish to issue new orders. Any questions, Master?
I have a mission to complete. Time to see what this ship can do.
Thank goodness you aren't deactivating me. Good luck. I regret I am unable to offer you combat support, Master. Frankly, my chassis couldn't withstand the stress. However, should any errands arise that are beneath your superior status, please do not hesitate to call upon me. I function to serve you. Whenever you are ready to depart, consult the galaxy map on your bridge. It will program the proper astrogation coordinates and activate the engines.
Apprentice, I trust you find your starship satisfactory?
It's an outstanding vessel.
I hope that it serves you well. There is much to be done. My interests must be protected and my enemies destroyed. Nomen Kaas' efforts to expose my spies and prove his Padawan's power to the Jedi Council must meet with systemic failure. You will exhaust yourself in this charge.
Where do you suggest I begin?
The information we siphoned from that Republic agent will be our map. We know my spy on Nar Shaddaa was being surveilled. We know where this Padawan was discovered, where she trained, and that the Jedi have sent someone to investigate my spy on Balmora. The Padawan will have to be hunted down and destroyed, but first you must secure my network by silencing my spies on Balmora and Nar Shaddaa.
Why not simply recall your spies?
Their disappearance would look suspicious, and serve to confirm the Padawan's accusations. My spies must die. My contacts on Balmora and Nar Shaddaa will detail what must be done. Your tasks are paramount, apprentice. Bring cruelty. Bring rage. Bring death.
Flight Commander Pyru, my lord. If you possess a ship, I could certainly use your talents. The Republic grows bolder. Their attack squadrons ambush Imperial targets and disappear into open space. We're struggling to compete.
Why would the Republic risk war over these space skirmishes?
Open warfare's just around the corner. They're likely probing us for weaknesses, readying for battle. I've scrambled the Cast 23rd and Dreadwing, but it's not enough. We're forming an exclusive response squadron, the Empire's Fury. With a Sith of your power leading the squadron, we'd crush the Republic in record time.
I will proudly lead the Empire's Fury.
Excellent, my lord. Your call sign will be Tempest. Uploading mission data to your ship now. You'll work alone, while the rest of the squadron assists throughout the galaxy. Strike with fury. Strike for the Empire.
Declaration. I have completed a full analysis of my functions, Master. I'm ready to liquidate high-threat undesirables with a 100% efficiency, as the Maker intended.
We will destroy the Empire's threats without restraint or remorse.
Praise. Hearing you speak is like reviewing my programming logs. We will function well together, Master. Oath. While aboard your starship, I will maintain constant vigilance. You may rest easy here. Your absolute security occupies my every calculation.
I'm rarely on this ship. We'll spend most of our time planetside.
Encouragement. I can provide security anywhere. A simple nod is all I require to activate my combat protocols. I anticipate liquidating a great many undesirables in your service, Master.
Okay, hey, Sith Master, person of questionable temper and such. I've been extra good with the behaving. Did you notice? So, how about taking the shock collar off me?
Give me your word that you'll still obey.
How about some non-obedient sort of following directions? Like a person instead of a pet?
You really can't be broken, can you?
Ugh. That is such a relief. So, what now? I mean, we're like a million miles from nowhere, and you've got the only ship.
You will remain with me and help achieve my goals.
Fantastic. Glad you could open up. We'll have to talk again sometime. You know, I was a slave when I was a little girl, before I got free. Sort of full circle, I guess.
You work for a Sith, as all in the Empire do, but your collar has been removed.
Right. I do appreciate the difference, believe me. My mother and sister and I were grabbed when I was little. I don't remember much of it. We worked the mines on Ryloth. Then they separated us. I got sold to a Rodian, then a Hutt. Then some sort of weird three-eyed thing.
I'm guessing your masters found you more trouble than you were worth.
Ha ha. Yeah. So I was never gonna get Slave of the Year. Anyway, I guess you know you've moved around too much when a Sith ship starts to feel like home.
This is home. And this is our strange little community.
I guess you're right.
Watch out, I don't start calling you Pops.
I assume you've settled in?
Trana para vora, na balale. Na, hai tang, su di amamentano, jovicio, agio, pania maria, amia, casano, mandida.
You flew a starship by yourself. How did you even get a hold of one if your homeworld doesn't have any?
Aranaja, caduto e cabavrem a natababer amia, casano, mandidare de tutudaraka, fita sonone al fossi jameni, timana, davanuia bija.
If you wiped out the whole crew, who was left to repair the vessel so you could leave?
Akayam, opekaya kimata, samajikava svaro da baharo chikichiya, kokasa otomna, eka viatinia adarita la bovekajime, chimine karana ki tejutoda mime mata, anabakora, anunisela.
Those friends of yours, who were they? Why did they attack Republic targets on Nar Shaddaa?
Avicaro vivida la laracota de vare, cavavavam, bilati vara jovie, cavichuta, batis, yanki, ambesis, and park.